It's Danko, y'all.
Talk to y'all, man.
You ever wake up and feel like winter cold heart? Icicles pierce sound charts like some sort of Christmas art. Bleed sound, this dogma belongs in an atheist pound. Surrounded by puppies wearing a satanic frown. Girls like the blindfolds and bound bondage puppets. I wear clothes with razor blades in any mosh pit. Exit bloody, rocky road muddy. If your bitch is putty in my hands, this putty is ugly. I represent a country that's built on stupidity. God never helped cause you pissed on the nativity. Trash rappers everywhere, the industry is littering. You sound like sound bites dithering. Yes, I bask in the withering winds outside the Menominee woods. Sledgehammer nail into your ominous hood. I'm dominant good, you don't have to believe. But you'll be talking about me even after I leave.
I want to see the day.
Sunny day, but it's so far away to get a glimpse. It got me squinting like a funny face. Got my Chucky's lace, but I just run in place. Such a waste. Got me going off the chains, kinda like a blunted mace. Finna run away, blast off fast like on delay. You don't get the picture, let me frame it like it's on display. My mind's like a room that I'm stuck in. Up on the 10th floor without a door, the only way out's if I'm jumping. See, I've been hanging on the edge by a thin rope. Let go and land on all them demons that I slaughtered with a pencil. See, when I pull a pin and boot my pocket, they all duck and start running. You swear to fuck it was a shoddy in a trench coat. The window's stuck, yeah, that shit's closed up. Soaked, I've been banging on it, but that shit don't budge. Just to get up with my head, gotta lift stone rocks. So I do it on the clock like a Flintstone does.
I want to see the day.
Fuck Browns.
Fuck bro.
Look at who we got now.
Yo, this is the Fuck Bro podcast. Now, humbly introducing the butt of all jokes from last week. The thunder from down under. The rubber glove inside your mother. The Mars Indelible Fire Starter.
Whatever. I do what I want.
It's Cuban Pete's cousin. Nah.
Whatever, I do what I want.
It's his illegitimate son, bro.
What up, Mars? Yeah,
I figured I'd just crawl out of bed and fucking say what's up to my good old fucking friends. You know, decided it'd just be a good time to just crawl out of bed and fucking mosey on down to the podcast. Real easy to get here, you know.
Yeah.
So, yeah, we did. We really held it down.
Didn't you say you just came from your grandma's house? Now you're trying to, you know. Didn't you say you just came from your grandma's house?
That's where his
bed
is.
Came from my grandma's house is a blessing and a privilege.
Bro, when you were at your grandma's house, did you happen to grab those CDs that she had for you?
Fuck, you know what? I didn't get my CDs, but I told her about the CD stack, and I told her I need to see her collection now. I was like, after the Pestilence package. She's like super grateful too, which is dope. She was like mind blown with the Pestilence fucking deluxe pre-order package with the Animal Farm. That's like a rare pre-order too. That shit's crazy.
Animal Farm.
That went out.
Yeah, the Animal Farm like pre-order shit. Yeah, she got the hookup. Which is dope actually, because like her and my mom, they like collect all the releases that I'm a part of too. So it's kind of ill. Anytime that my homies drop some shit, like I got no shame, bro. I'm all about that. Like. I fucking let them know, and they always cop whatever, you know, if I'm a part of a project. So that's kind of cool.
You should be ashamed of yourself.
Yeah.
That being said, we're thinking of re-releasing Fat and Violent Mars 1. You should get on one track. We sold a couple copies already.
He only jumps on diss tracks that we do.
Yeah, we'll put a diss track on the next one. But Fat and Violent literally was like 30 seconds or less away from being too full for the CD. It was like 79 minutes and like 30 seconds long.
Well, you know, no one wants to listen to Mars rap for longer than 30 seconds anyway, so that's perfect.
Good point.
Mars, you wanna hop into and do some dubs on my hook?
Hey, isn't Animal Farm that one fucking album that Jocko fucking dropped?
Yeah, it's that Jocko project.
It sounds like a ripoff of Cuban Pete's Human Zoo.
Fucking Besto got today, the idea looking at Jocko's shirt. He's like, those ketchup stains look kind of like blood.
Yeah. Speaking of Jocko, Jockness Monster Entertainment, once again, our sponsor today,
hey,
bringing us the Mars One, presented to you by Jockness Monster Entertainment. Jocko's my brada.
What?
Yeah. He did a lot of back end work today to help us bring Mars One here. Obviously, we couldn't fucking do it ourselves. So we reached out to the brother Jocko. He was like, oh fuck, Mars is staying in Uganda.
Well, I mean,
let me give him a call.
It just so happened that he was at Mars One's grandma's house already. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, so, I mean, dropping off those CDs. That's right.
Yo, can we talk about this for a second? The fuck happened?
Your glasses? What happened?
Yeah, I'm coming to the end of an era, bro. I'm gonna get some douchey ass glasses for my next fucking arc.
No, you gotta keep the bottle cap Supremes, bro.
Get some aviators. These are prescription.
Yeah.
You gotta keep those young Elton Johns that you'd be rocking.
Young Eltons.
I think this is a good time to
You what?
To drop an ad. I think this is a good time to drop an ad for Jockness Monster's glasses repair kits. You know what I'm saying?
Oh yeah, that's right.
Oh yeah.
He did out with those.
Yeah. The Jockness Monster eyeglass repair kit.
I feel like that came out and there wasn't nearly enough shine on it, you know?
Yeah. Right. That's the thing. A lot of people think Jocko's just this flashy dude that goes and gets, you know, information about Brody Dudester and passes it to the team.
And he has a lot of friends in India too, bro.
Yeah. A lot of people think he's all about the flash. Yeah, but Bangladesh. He'd be out here putting in hours for the working man too. And, you know, he developed a state-of-the-art, top-of-the-line eyeglass repair kit. It's an all-in-one tool that fits conveniently into your wallet and carry it around with you everywhere. He said that was really the biggest thing he saw missing in the eyeglass repair kit market, was that usually that even though they're a small size, you know, it's kind of inconvenient to be carrying that around. So he's like, man, if I could develop a tool that we could just slide into your wallet, it'd revolutionize the game. And
that's not how it
happened.
He was sitting eating chicken wings at the bar, and fucking the bartender was like, yo, my fucking lens came out. And then Jocko, he like used his mouth like an octopus suction cup or something like that and put it back in. I don't remember. I forgot how it went.
Something like that.
Yeah,
Jockness Monster Entertainment. A man of many talents.
Maybe it was the way you said.
Jocko's my brother.
Yeah. Warp.
Warp.
But anyway, speaking of good times to get into something, I think that it would be a good time to get into how we fucking came to be meeting Mars One. And how a young MC from fucking middle of bumfuck nowhere, New Mexico, now hailing from Tucson, is a member of fucking Two-Face Media.
That's right.
Yeah. I know. I remember the fucking first time that we met, and I know Space will too, I'm sure. I'm sure all three of us will. It wasn't that fucking long ago, so if we don't remember it, we should probably get checked for a tumor in our head or something. But out at Utah, all of our first Grind Mode Cypher event that we went to, I remember Mars coming up to us all like fucking, like, super social man energy, and was like, yo, dude, Space Case, I heard of you. And he like said, I think you knew certain T. And you were like, yeah, dude, I know you guys. And you brought like the most ragtag group of individuals, like Miklo and fucking Seth.
Fucking like, Seth and Miklo.
We saw Miklo before we got there and we're like laughing about him because he's like wearing a fucking 80s Magnum PI shirt and like he's got a fucking giant mullet and a mustache. And he's just like fucking.
I fucking love that guy.
Just like, yeah, his energy and bravado is just hilarious. And we saw him walking down the street before we fucking got to the event, like not knowing he was going to come to that event. But then, of course, he fucking shows up with Mars One and part of his crew. And then, like, our crew was like me, Space, and fucking Christian from Mad World. And then Tap Daddy had kind of coalesced with us. We met up with him out there, too. So we had like a weird little collective sitting in the corner. With the fucking only other merch table there, which was also kind of weird for us to be like, hey, man, like, no one else has merch. You mind if we set our shit up back here?
I remember there was like a CBD table. Some people were like selling CBD and shit. Like, get the fucking shit out of here.
Yeah, dude. There was, yeah, that was a, it was a, that was fucking nice because it was like outside. It was fucking nice outside. We all got to fucking kind of to kick it. And the other thing that I thought was fucking hilarious is because we just did that event. We said hello, didn't socialize with each other at all. And then later, you know, obviously we met through me reaching out and I moved down to New Mexico. We became fucking brothers. But one thing I learned well after the fact is that when I was at this event, I had some mushrooms and I was like, I'm gonna take these after I was done with my ciphers. And I took them and I was fucking blasted, like, oh shit, like I'm getting hit in the fucking chest by Jay Savage, thinking I'm standing too close, not realizing this guy's just got fucking the longest arms known to fucking man, and he's just hitting me in the fucking chest while he's doing his fucking arm motions and shit, and I'm thinking like, oh fuck, dude, I'm gonna get kicked out of here for like fucking up the video, I'm getting too close or something, like shit, I have nowhere to go though, what the fuck do I do? And come to find out, me and Mars talk about this in hindsight, and this motherfucker was also on mushrooms while we were there. Somebody, like, just fucking randomly came out of the crowd, some fucking dude, and was like, hey, man, you want some fucking mushrooms?
Yo, so, like, Space, you were there, so I don't know if anybody particularly remembers this dude, but there was a fucking guy, and he looked exactly like Snowball from Clerks, bro. I don't know, that's, like, a very specific character for the movie Clerks. This guy, Snowball, this nasty motherfucker. He looked like this fucking dude. And he's like, yo, man. He like, I'm in the crowd just like watching. I think it was probably during your guys' set, which is hilarious. So I was like watching Tap Daddy fucking skanking around in this fucking business suit. Fucking that dude's such a fucking pimp. You guys had such a dope like dynamic going on. I was like, what the fuck are these guys? Like, what is this crew? This is so like versatile and dope. And the way that you guys bounce off each other, it was a really dope thing that you guys performed. Like in the introduction with a set from you guys is like, it's ill, but so what's funny, what Pesto was saying is like, I was after the after his fucking set, I was like, yo, dude, that was dope, man, good shit, you're pretty dope, bro. And he was like, thank you, and just like walked away. And just like kept fucking going. I was like, all right, he's about his fucking business. I didn't know what to like. I'm super like positively, I'm gonna give you the benefit of the doubt if you're in a fucking mask anyway, you know, like this guy's very unique anyway. Yeah, he's just like, thanks. Just, that was it. I thought it was time for a fucking combo or like, yeah, dude, what's your Instagram or some shit like everyone else is doing. They're like, yeah, bro, what's your fucking name? Like, yeah, I'm so-and-so. He's like, thanks. And just fucking dips out, bro. Just onward, bro. And yeah, Space, I remember like you had heard a song of mine. And that's, I was familiar like when we linked up at the fucking cypher, like you had mentioned, I think it was the Arsonist joint. You're like, hey, I heard that song this week or something. That was dope. And I was familiar with like certain tease beats or something like that. And I'd vaguely, like, I just seen you guys just off of, you know, the pre cypher type politics and shit like that. Man, the rest is fucking history. It's crazy too, because it's so early in the brohood. Like, it's only a couple years deep, but it's dope that it's already been a couple years since then. Like, it's been like two, almost 3 years or something, right?
Yeah. I think it'd be three this year. Yeah.
I guess,
yeah, so that's pretty much. Yeah, but I don't know.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure.
You guys drove, and I was tripped out because you guys drove like almost double the amount that we drove. We drove like 13 hours. You guys went a whole fucking day, huh?
I thought you were like, you're like, yeah, dude, we drove fucking 13 hours, or like we drove 22.
Like, also, what the fuck is wrong with you guys? Jesus. So you guys are dedicated, bro.
It was a trip. Obviously, like, space is a fucking big individual. And thankfully, like, the other three that were in the vehicle were not large individuals. Because I thought about how long that trip was. And I thought about, like, if it wasn't Christian and G, it was me, you, I'd be bumping and Nate Nasty in that same vehicle. Like,
that would have been fucking
chore. That just wouldn't have worked.
It just
the fucking axle wouldn't.
It was.
You guys would have hated each other by the end of that shit.
And both
I hate you guys thinking about it.
Both of the fucking ciphers that we did and that we drove, like, fucking, I think the other one we drove 18 hours to go to Worcester. Both of those ciphers, and we didn't fucking plan it out this way. It wasn't like I was thinking about it. No one was, like, trying to set this up to avoid it. Both of them, I ended up getting fucking rush hour Chicago traffic on the fucking main freeway. And the one time, I was in the furthest left lane, and the only lane we could use was the very far right one. And it was fucking gridlock traffic up to the fucking toll booths. Do you remember that space? And I had to cut across fucking 15 lanes of traffic.
I must have been sleeping at that time, man.
You were not sleeping. We were all awake. And I had to go fucking sideways across stopped traffic.
Oh, and beat I remember.
Yes,
we were taking pictures and shit, man.
Yeah, it was a fucking terrible time. But, nah, man, it was, like Mars, like you said, it was, the rest is history, but, like, so back to, like, you saying, you fucking dapping me up after the set, so one thing that a lot of people don't realize, and a lot of people do now, but, this mask fogs up super fucking easy. So when I'm performing, by the time I'm done performing, like, I have never had a set where I could see afterwards. Like, it is literally, like, almost blind walking around. Like, I'm starting to tap into my inner Ray Charles. Like, I'm fucking sonar vision walking through fucking places. You're, like,
sensing shit now?
Yeah. So I gotta, like, wipe out the lenses real good and wipe my whole face off and shit so that I don't, like, radiate the heat to fog them right back up again. And there's so many times that people come and, like, try to have, like, a full in-depth conversation with me as soon as I get off the stage. And it's, like, there's only been a couple times that, like, somebody's, like, really grabbed me and was like, hey. And, like, I couldn't get away. And I'm just remember thinking the whole time, like, dude, you're, like, trying to connect with me right now. And I have no idea what you look like at all. So, like, it's happened before where, like, people have talked to me. And then, like, throughout the night, I'm, like, trying to, like, put the face to the voice that I remember hearing. I'm, like, listening in on conversations, like, who the fuck was the guy that was talking to me for, like, 15 minutes? Because I don't know what it's like at all.
That's tough.
Dude, it's fucking crazy. But it does make me, like, laugh. I'm, like, all right, it's kind of, like, a weird disconnection to the fucking being there. It almost makes it feel like wearing this is fucking, like watching a movie. Like you're like in a theater. You're not actually
on the set. It totally seems like it'd be a different perspective for sure, bro. That's
it's
shit.
Fucking weird, man.
Your whole fucking reality, you know.
It does, and it opens the doors to a lot of sexual indiscretions.
I was about to say to a whole bunch of nasty dance moves. You fucking
by like old. Oh yeah, to the dance moves. I gotta tap into the inner pesto as well. But anyway, enough about us and Mars One. What is our one submission that we have today, Mr. Netananaste?
I don't see him. Where is he at?
I forgot.
I don't see him either.
I think it is from another Two-Faced Media brother, the DW Underground.
DW?
Isn't it that joint with him and Scoob Rock?
Oh, yeah.
Yep. Yep.
Mm-hmm. It is.
French fried potatoes.
Mm-hmm.
Yarp.
Do you forget about them? You don't need them to win. Keep your loved ones close. Happy wife, happy life. Music is life, life is music. Without it, might lose it. Surf over beats, speak from the heart. Can't do it the other way, cause I care about the art. Pave my lane, play my part. Been this way ever since start. No handouts or licking ass to earn clout. Always in my DMs like give a fuck what you on about. Antics won't last in the ring with a line. I see what you want, I see what you're trying. But around there, that shit ain't flying. You better man up and stop the blood clot crying. Do you forget about them? You don't need them to win. Keep your loved ones close. Happy wife, happy life. Do you forget about them? You don't need them to win. Keep your loved ones close. Happy wife, happy life. We have to give thanks and praise, we are no day. Close guy, take a deep breath and feel nice. My reach is long, why be weak when I can be firm and strong? My threads are cut from a fabric unknown. Claim to be the man, but you're not even the king of your own home. Stop the bullshitting, you ain't sitting on no throne. Lost in lies, trapped in the danger zone. You teach people something, run with it, never give you credit. Quick to edit, backtrack and now you said it. Never been a bitch like you, say what I mean and mean what I say. Do you forget about them? You don't need them to win. Keep your loved ones close. Happy wife, happy life. Do you forget about them? You don't need them to win. Keep your loved ones close. Happy wife, happy life. That don't look back, keep the future in sight. Let them envy, but it's alright. See you when I see you, nigga. But when I do, it's on sight. Bars every bunch of months a week, way past the peak. Do you not care about them? Hard work always wins in the end.
Yes, they love me, I'm sending me family them. All that idiot, I've got mine saving. I'm safe to be around that.
Good energy keeps me so inspired. Make me climb over hills and valleys. Together with wife observes the horizon, horizon. Do you forget about them? You don't need them to win. Keep your loved ones close. Happy wife, happy life. Do you forget about them? You don't need them to win. Keep your loved ones close. Happy wife, happy life.
Holy fuck, bro.
Fuck, bro. Fuck.
Fuck, bro.
Fuck, bro.
Hey, fuck, bro.
Yo, I'm gonna have to jump back in. I don't know. My shit's having like, it's like glitching like motherfucker. 1 second, guys. I'm gonna jump back in real quick.
But.
All right.
That was the homie DW Underground and Scoob Rock. What was the song called? Guys, and we are having some technical difficulties. Very technical difficulty.
I don't know what the song's called, man. I think it's called Do You.
I think so, too. Let me just double check. I don't want to get it wrong.
Right. All right, right, wrong.
It is Frig. It is Do You. Yes, it is Do You. I see Bumpin's there. I know Bumpin said that he had company coming over, so it's very possible that he is currently muted because of that. So, God damn it. So anyway, I guess we can just kind of kick it off and talk about it. What did you think of that joint?
And I'm a fan of that one. I've listened to the track a few times, and you know, I listen to it on my phone. I listen to it on the speaker when it comes on the speaker at work, which also has like no depth to it. Like it's super flat. So it's cool hearing this track with headphones on, like actually like being able to hear the depth and all that shit. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, man, I dig this track. I like Scoob Rock, man. I like his flow. I like his voice. I like the way that he approaches the track. He's another one too where I've heard him on a few different tracks now, and I'm a fan, man. I like his shit. I wish he would rhyme a little more, but that's just because I'm just the fucking traditional head, I guess. I don't fucking know. But I don't know, man. He's still solid. Yeah, and then DW, you know, that beat is dope. And I know Scoob Rock. What?
I think he was just agreeing with you that the beat was dope.
Oh, I thought he was about to start talking shit, this motherfucker. Yeah, yeah. And I know Scoob Rock engineered the track as well, and I think he did a pretty good fucking job. It's weird, like, hearing it on the headphones, I feel like his vocals could come up, but, you know, hearing it and the flat tones that I've heard it, you know, just like I said, on my phone and on the fucking that shitty speaker at work, like, it sounded fucking perfect. So, regardless, I'm gonna give this motherfucker a yes. Good job, gentlemen. DW, the fam. Good job.
Okay.
Nicely done.
Same. Yeah, I could hear it.
Yeah, I didn't believe it.
Yes, we were.
Some of those, yeah.
Yo, I'll go next. Because I want to ask you guys. I got like a wave of nostalgia from like when I was the early 2000s era, like shit that you would hear on like some of the hip hop radio, and I want to say like his vocal tone and delivery reminds me of like, is it Ja Rule that sounds like that? It does kind of like hit just his voice more so, not really like what he's rhyming about or nothing, but like just kind of his voice and like the melodies and shit that he naturally has, like particularly in the hook. Like it kind of gave me that like that vibe from that era, like in terms of like the style and the flavor on it. But I thought it was really fucking dope. Like I like the I see what Space was saying about like the rhyming in certain parts too, because like I think like when he goes off into like the patois, it kind of loses me a little bit, because like it's something about like the way that sounds, even like audio wise versus like when he's just rapping, doesn't sound as appealing to me on this song in particular, because like I remember that Postman joint, like he did a lot of that, and I actually really enjoyed it there.
Fuck.
So I don't know if that was on the engineering side or if it's more on the writing side, but despite that, like it's still like the song was like a really fucking dope vibe. I think DW really set the stage with this beat, was really fucking soulful, like that fucking sample was crazy, and it had just like a nice kind of fucking hypnotic chaining to it that like really fucking set the stage for him to fucking like make something vibe you with. Like it's definitely not like a beat that I would expect to hear something like that on, but it's like, man, like, because like I'm always trying to turn shit into something that's more so lyrical, and I know like a lot of us are kind of more on that lyrical point, and not saying that this beat wouldn't serve that well too, I'm sure that would be fucking dope, but like hearing something that's kind of like more deep and soulful, I think this beat really brings that out and like made it a very enjoyable listening experience. So I'm also gonna give it a yes.
Oh, Oh, shit.
I'd be bumping. Are you still there? You there with your fucking Raptors?
Yo, yo, I'm here real quick. Well, let's hear what Mars One guy has to say about that track first.
Well, from what I could hear, unfortunately, the fucking Discord started getting, like, delayed and kind of glitched out and shit. Unfortunately. But, like, from what I could hear, that shit was, like Pesto had mentioned, what my first impression from the joint was like, nostalgic. And I think that that's what DW does really well with his selection of samples. You know, I know that he caters more into the soulful realm, which you can never really get enough of, if you ask me, really. And it's kind of like his trademark style, but he does a really good, of course, varied styles too, but like rock and soul and like funk, dude can pump out some fucking bangers. And so my first impression was nice and soulful. Everything that I heard from the MC is Scoob Rock, right?
Yeah.
Yep.
Everything that I've heard from him, because I heard a recent joint, I believe it was from both of them. I don't know if it was a teaser or what. The dude's dope to me too. Like, unfortunately, I didn't really get to hear the whole joint, man, or I'd have a really more concise fucking criticism for it, you know? But like, my Discord started fucking up. So, from what I could hear, super solid though. I don't know. Voice on the hook sounded really nice. It's just that it was like, on my end, it was delayed and it was like glitchy and shit a little bit. So, I would feel like it'd be injustice to really try to just like give a review that I can't truly, you know? But it sounded dope from what I could hear, for real. It sounded nice. Sounds like they got good chemistry together.
Yeah,
because my computer was kind of being like that a little bit, but...
Yeah, I don't know why I was doing that shit. I need to go to my computer and get off my phone.
I was getting like a 50 Cent vibe, but maybe that's because I'm fucking chopped, and I was thinking of Ja Rule. Or I was thinking of them beefing. Yeah. You know, well, 50 Cent...
I can hear what you're saying. I hear what you're saying with some of the some of the hooks that 50's done, like, definitely have a similar vibe to that.
I saw a post saying that fucking Ja Rule, 50 Cent blamed Ja Rule for the Knicks losing the series. He's like, they let that dirty, crusty motherfucker hold the NBA trophy, and now they haven't won a game since.
Yeah.
It's just petty. He's just, they've been beefing for like decades, bro. It's just funny.
Oh, man.
I've been watching a lot of NBA shit. Like, just
I know,
because, you know,
it's actually one of my favorite arcs is that, like, none of us are, like, super following the seasons ever. Like, I never hear anybody talk about it. Yeah. And, like, I don't either. But I still, like, when Milwaukee's in it, I'm rooting for Milwaukee. I'm excited to see it. And it's, like, they just won recently, so it wasn't, like... And I didn't really have high hopes for this postseason, so I wasn't really rooting for it. But it's, like, it was kind of cool to see Bumpin', who I've never seen post anything related to sports, like, drop it in the chat and being, like, yo, the Timberwolves or the Wolves just shoved their dicks down the Nuggets' throat. I'm so excited about it now.
Bro, we're Minnesota, bro. So, like, we have nothing.
I get it, bro.
We've had nothing to say. It's like Al Jefferson, you know, after KG left, it was like, Al Jefferson, and then we're whack. Yeah. Kevin Love, and then we're whack. And it's just, you know, so we're just like used to heartbreak, but now it's like we have a good team. And I do feel bad for the Bucks because I really like them too. Giannis is dope as fuck, but he's getting like fucked over, man. Like, he should have got MVP, you know.
They don't give. I mean, because if they were gonna give awards to people that deserved it, that rookie kid would have got Defensive Player of the Year this year, and they didn't give it to him. And it's like he led the fucking league in like he led the league in so many defensive categories, and it's like. Yeah, I don't know. But I understand it because, like, I do think, and it's something that I've mentioned, like, when I work in a bar, when I talk to people about, like, the sports, I'm like, you know, I'm always a fan of the hometown team because when the hometown team is doing well, it impacts the business that I work in positively.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So it's like, and it's just, it is something that, like, I've gotten to experience with, like, the Packers winning a Super Bowl. And even to a smaller degree when the Bucks won the championship, just like everybody around right. you, like just strangers are just like a little happier. They're like,
after
yeah,
the Wolves beat the fucking Nuggets in game 7, after going down by 20, I was watching the game here at my house and they were down and I was like, fuck this. And I went over to Greg's house and he was watching the game. And when I got there, they were tied up. And I was like, wait, what? Are we watching the same game?
You watching a replay, motherfucker?
Yeah. And then they won, bro. And literally driving down the res all late at night, like, Wolves won out the window. Because nobody gave a dude. We all, like, just stopped watching basketball, bro. I swear to God, bro. There was nothing good. It was, you know what, I'm so sick of the Wolves.
How long into that song did it?
Oh, yeah, I voted it, yeah, you guys. By the way.
Did you,
you guys
any,
heard the whole song?
It did
yeah,
play.
We, I did.
It played for us, yeah. It was kind of, I don't know how to, I could tell it was some buffering shit going
you'll
on.
You'll have to definitely with this one yeah. put the actual song on it. The and we have the MP3 file already, so it shouldn't be too hard.
Is Mars frozen for you guys too?
He's not. He's just stoic. he might be. He said it was glitching like a motherfucker.
Dude, Mars, he starts moving. Mars is just stoic. Yo, I'm zooming in on that real quick.
Bro, hit us with the Easter Island head.
Oh, shit. Dude, Discord's whack right now, but we'll make do with what we can, I guess. It's whack.
Yeah, I know. Are you guys having a storm by you? I know we're...
Yeah, we are.
Kind of a little bit, sort of.
Nasty storms right now.
Sick forecast right now. Sick foreskin forecast.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're on a tornado watch yet.
Yeah, that's how Mars looked. And now it's all just loading. You know,
cloudy
I think it's
with a chance of FUPA.
I think it's Mars. It's fucking us up on purpose because we're bombing on Cuban Pete and their homies.
Yeah, dude. He's like fucking hitting us with a fucking... Like I said, dude, he was fucking planting the seed and fucking getting in there. Stop fucking.
He's on the phone with, he had to take a call with Cuban Pete.
That's right. The like, long
I've infiltrated
distance
the new
fucking...
server.
Yeah. We're in there. Hey, so, about them space case beats? Yeah. They're trying to get your beats. Yeah.
What?
Oh, when Mars comes back, if he mentions your beats, he's gonna, you know, he's doing it because he's trying to get Cuban Pete some of them beats.
I don't like those
100.
Shout out to Wishmaster.
I'm the only one that has the power to fucking conjure the fucking emoji thumbs. I'm the only one that can walk on both sides.
Is it because you got the fucking special shit? I don't know. I just got regular Discord.
No, I just have regular Discord too. Nate couldn't do this last week. Pesto's the only one that can put his thumbs on the screen in emoji form.
There he goes.
Just by holding them up. It's an AR experience.
Shout out to Anno Domini for making it so easy for us rappers to get on features with these big artists so we could catfish our fans.
Hey. Hey. Thank you.
Shout out to Wishmaster for just giving away that Chris Calico feature.
Man, it's the first time. It's the first time I actually got a lot of streams without having to actually buy it. You know what I'm saying? So, hey.
Hey.
I appreciate that shit.
Yeah.
It's like the first song where my likes to views ratio is realistic, you know?
I like how people—they're like, people are like, I like the version with you on it better. Like they sat and listened to a bunch of them before they came across yours. This must be a remix. That's right, dude. Fucking Wishmaster, Legion Beats, Anno Domini. You guys are fucking. shit up. Keep up the good job.
You're also fucking little weasel nerds. I've seen a fucking podcast with all of them sitting in a fucking room together. Looking at you, Gabe. You fucking...
Mars One is back. We were just talking about your favorite producer, Anno Domini.
Oh, yeah. That guy fucking rocks, bro.
That's how...
Yeah.
That's Mars's producer, actually.
He's like our main go-to guy. Well,
he's like, yeah, dude, that's actually the homie. He's hooked me up with lots of features.
You can't beat $30 for 500 beats with 10 exclusive verses from dead rappers, man.
Yep.
Yeah. It's a fucking honor, bro, to fucking do this track with DMX.
I like how... He always sends an email like, this is your last chance. Get it while it's hot. And then he sends me an email like, fuck it. Any, pick a pack. Like, pick any one of our packs. I'm going to go through and be like, is that fucking Chris Calico one there so I can get my disappear track on?
Like on that fucking, like, yo, man, you got any more of that Chris Calico Wishmaster, man?
Yeah.
I need some of that, man.
All right, so what do we got next, Nate? Sean
Up
Crutch.
Next, we have a song that was submitted to us by Space Case over here. Sean Crutch with The Struggle.
Oh.
Hell yeah. Fuck, let's check that shit out then.
Sounds like my morning.
Body cast, painkillers, x-rays, surgical stitches, morphine heavens, one hell of an addiction. Prep the anesthetic, we bout to start the incision. This is not a fable, operating table, I be stuck inside my temple. Images are detrimental, I see you as instrumental. Muscle tissue torn, body was deformed, ligaments have been disfigured. Life is hanging on the temple. I'm trying to paint a mental picture. I remember 15, popping codeine, hoping that the mental take control. I was trying to stack a pose, cause my mama didn't know. Cause I used to throw me on his back and have me wrap my hands around his throat. Temperature was freezing cold, that's how I made it through the snow. Feeling all alone and completely useless, wondering just how my life was conducive. Searching for a cure, it was too elusive. Coping mechanism was making music. Fall from my hands, cut scars and bruises. Knots on my head, but clients and contusions. Feeling like a scene from Back to the Future, cause I was like Michael J. Fox with the movements. I thought pops was tripping, had me tiny splitting while we in the kitchen doing long division. Lighting in my mental, killing inhibitions. Needed intervention, yeah, the pain was vicious. Violence and fiddles, I was in my feelings, but I wouldn't whimper, it was not permitted. Pray God forgive me for my past existence and the simple pleasures I can. The struggle's real. The struggle's real. The struggle's real. Yeah. The struggle's real. Yeah. I see the devil all around me. I'm praying to the Lord, hoping that he saved my soul. The path is dark and I don't know which way to go. I'm trying to find my way home. I see the devil all around me. I'm praying to the Lord, hoping that he saved my soul. The path is dark and I don't know which way to go. I'm trying to find my way home.
I ain't trying to hear you crying on the record. How you struggle on the block. You ain't got no brittle bones. It ain't hurting when you walk. You ain't never fell down yelling help in an empty parking lot. You ain't never had to spend 2 hours in the morning putting on your socks. Praying for a fighting chance, exercising all I can. Crawling using just my hands, legs as weak as rubber bands. Granny Shirley used to tell me, honey, you can do whatever you envision. Guess I took away too early, telling God I really messed
up. The struggle's real. The struggle's real. The struggle's real.
yeah. The struggle's real. I see the devil all around me. I'm praying to the Lord, hoping that he saved my son. If heaven's dark and I don't know which way to go, I'm trying to find my way home. I see the devil all around me. I'm praying to the Lord, hoping that he saved my soul. If heaven's dark and I don't know which way to go, I'm trying to find my way home.
Oh, fuck, bro.
Fuck, bro.
Goddamn.
Fuck, bro.
That was holy fuck, bro.
Submitted by the Jester Exodus. Jester, you want to tell us why you submitted that song?
Man, so, you know, Sean Crutch is a name that we're somewhat familiar with over here. You know, we brought him up to Sturgeon Bay a couple times, and then, like, I was listening to his music, you know what I'm saying, but, like, it didn't really hit, you know what I mean? But then, like, at the Mad World Cypher in Green Bay, he did this song live, and, like, man, the fucking beat, bro, that fucking beat is insane, dude.
I like, knew I you were going to say something about the beat. It's oh, so dope, fuck, isn't it?
Bro. And it's like, man, that's just so crazy. And I'm hearing it live, bro. Like, I get the fucking chills just thinking about that shit. But, like, man, like, me and Certain T were standing next to each other. We just, like, look at each other at the same time. Just fucking cheesy. And, man, like, I can fucking see the hair standing up on his arms, too, man. Like, it was fucking nuts. And then, like,
then
Sean Crutch started rapping. And then it was like, I don't know, like, he had my attention, you know what I'm saying? Like, I was fucking listening. And, like, I don't know. I know he raps about the shit he's been through. You know, I know he addresses it quite a bit throughout his music. Like, it's a reoccurring theme. But, man, like, I don't know. This song right here, like, this is, like, fucking flawless. It's cool, you know, because Sean Crush, he's got his health issues, you know what I'm saying? And he really flips them, you know, from like a weakness to a strength, you know what I'm saying? And this track specifically, I think Sean Crush shines. He's got some other tracks on this album too that are just fucking so dope, man. So fucking dope. But this one hits. this one definitely hits a little bit. So, yeah. Sean Crush, man, I know I gave you props on this track before. You know, after you did the live, we gave you props. And then, like, I had to fucking look the song up right away, and I found it. And I fucking listened to this shit. And, you know I hit you up on fucking Messenger also giving you props. Because, yeah, man, this is it. This fucking track is it. So... Yeah, I know. I asked him who the producer was. I don't think he ever answered me. But yeah, bro, that fucking beat is crazy.
Yeah, that was
dope. Oh man, hell yeah!
I was digging that hard. Shit. I got
so. Oh, I'm assuming it's obviously a yes from you then.
Well, yeah, he's not gonna upload a song. Yeah. He's not gonna pick a song and say no.
Well, maybe he will.
Here, I'll go
why
next.
My ass is a big fucking break.
I wanted to say something too because the beat was fucking really fucking dope, and it was like, man, dude, Sean Crutch, he's always reminded me of Young Jeezy, and I love Young Jeezy. That's just dope, and the chorus though, man. That was a really good fucking song. Like, you know, it's no accident that, you know, Jesse Exodus is going to hear, because he's super picky with his songs. He'd be like, it's not my cup of tea per se, but like, he knew it was going to be fire already. So that is definitely going to get a yeah from me, because Sean Crutch is the homie. And that was a dope ass track. Pesto.
Oh yeah.
So I don't know if he came up in the fucking frame, but our conversation earlier about pizza conjured the fucking pizza man to my fucking door when I was outside smoking a cigarette. Christian must have ordered a fucking pizza. And he was the coolest pizza guy of all time. Like, he talked to me and was like, hey, what's up, man? He's like, do you know which apartment this one is? And then, like, he fucking talked. He's like, god damn, it's fucking crazy weather, huh? I'm like, yeah. And he's like, I really like the mask. And I was like, oh, thanks, dude. And then he fucking, I'll text Christian. He comes down, fucking pays for the pizza. I'm listening to the song. And then the guy was just like, yo, you better run up there and steal some of that food, man. And, like, said some shit, and then he took off. But I was fucking listening to the song. The first verse was kind of when I talked to him a little bit, so I missed a little bit of the content in there, but it's definitely a song I want to go back and check out, and just really listen to the whole song, because, once I did really get to start listening, like, I think this is probably, I mean, I can't say probably, this is definitely my favorite joint I've heard from Sean, for a variety of reasons, like, not saying that the other stuff that we've heard and stuff I've heard from him before doesn't have, like, a depth to it or the same kind of whatever, but, like, this just has a different power to it. Like, I think between his delivery and his flow on this one, the beat itself, and just the content, everything, I feel like he checked all the boxes. It wasn't like, I really liked this, but then, you know, a hook came in, or I didn't like the layout, or I didn't like this. Like, there's always been, like, something that kind of held me back from, like, really fucking, damn, this shit's fucking dope to me. You know, like, I've always thought, like, he's very skilled, and I could see, like, the potential and stuff that, like, man, I definitely know that there's something in his catalog that would really speak to me. And this is one of them for sure. Because, like, I think the content and the way that he talks about it, Space kind of touched on it, like, turning the weakness into a strength thing. And it's something that, like, I've dealt with, like, a disabling illness since I was 11 years old. And, like, hearing the way he talks about, like, you know, you ain't never been through this, you ain't never been through that, different kinds of stuff, like, that definitely hits in a way. Being somebody that's dealt with, like, some fucking long-term debilitating shit, and it's like one of those things where it's like that is a fucking thought process that exists within anybody that's chronically ill. I think that, like, regardless of what your situation is in life, you still have to fucking exist, you still have to work, you still have to do stuff, you still have to support yourself, you still have to fucking grind in your own way, and it definitely is another thing that makes that more difficult. And I know that it's a pretty common thing that, you know, there's a lot of people out there when you're just working and you're in the regular fucking world that people are kind of selfish and lack, like, a common empathy everywhere. So it's like you do have, I'm sure Sean's gone through this too, when you work with people and you have issues with your health, some people don't fucking get it. And they think, well, I've been sick before. But no, you haven't. Not like that. You haven't been, like you said, no, you haven't. You haven't been through this. You haven't been through that. I think, like, that there's a real power to that. And like Bump said with, like, the hook was really fucking good. It was very depth, you know, it was very in-depth, and it, like, fit the fucking whole concept of the song. Like, it tied everything together. And I really like that he allowed that beat to breathe with the way that he delivered the hook, and also with the way that he organized the song, and, like, at the end, kind of letting that sample and the beat kind of fade out and be part of, like, hey, this, it's a powerful beat. So letting it speak for itself at some point, I think, was a really, really wise decision from an engineering standpoint. So I'm also going to give it a yes. Nate Nasty.
Yeah, I liked it. It's getting a yes. I love the flow. His inner bar patterns, they went hard as fuck. And, like, I agree. Like, Sean Crutch brings, like, a light to the struggles that he faced. And it's inspiring and heavy stuff, even though, like, I don't face those same struggles. You know, it's some good shit. All right. Bump, and I do hear the similarities to Jeezy, but I think that's just, like, his voice a little bit. But, like, I don't know. Because lyrically, he's a whole other monster. But, yeah. So that's a yes for me.
He's more crafty with his
rhymes
than Jeezy.
Don't fucking suck your teeth at me, Bumpin'. Don't you suck your teeth at me. I saw you over there, you fucking motherfucker. Hitting him with that. Don't hit me with the fathom teeth, you motherfucker.
That was a little fade face.
So, what do you think, Mars One?
Yo, is your guys' cameras on or am I tripping?
Our cameras are on.
Your connection might be, when you're on your phone, sometimes it doesn't show you everybody if your connection's not, like, stellar at certain points.
All right, or so if here, hopefully, aren't stellar, if so. I turn my shit on, I don't mind. Hold up. Can you motherfuckers see me?
Yeah, we can now.
Yeah.
All right, cool. I can't see you guys, but check this out. I'll restart my shit in a second. This is the first song that I heard from Sean Crutch, but I heard him on the Cyphers, the Mad World Cyphers. He was dope and everything, but this was super fucking dope. And this is it's a good, like, introduction to somebody who hasn't heard a song from the dude. Like, this is one I'd recommend because it, like Pesto had mentioned too, it checks a lot of those boxes for sure. Like, not only is the beat super good, of course, the beat's fucking dope. It's one of those beats I think everyone kind of wishes that they could fucking rhyme on to a certain level. Not like everybody, but it's one of those. It's very desirable kind of a beat. It's ill. But then the creativeness that he showed with the flows was the selling point for that shit. It was dope. And his voice is crazy because like he's from your guys' area, right?
He's from Chicago.
Okay, so more or less ish. I mean, he's in that part of the country. He like sounds like he reminded me of like Sauce. This dude Sauce Walk, like
Spaghetti One, bro.
He's like some tech kind of me a little bit. Kind of southern-ish, but like just rugged, and you could tell there's experience. I think in that dude, just like cadence, the way that you could tell like he's been through some shit just based off of just the voice, and I think that's dope. I think it's fucking dope. So that was a good song. I'm gonna like check that shit out after this podcast. Go put it on the playlist. So
damn,
I give that motherfucker.
So that's a fuck bro, fuck bro, fuck bro, fuck bro, fuck bro, fuck bro, fuck bro.
Yeah, dude, now there's five fuck bros once more to be said. Fuck bro, fuck bro, fuck bro, fuck bro, fuck bro.
All right.
Broke up, bro. But yes.
Well, either way.
Either way, that's 5 out of 5. That's a better score than 4 out of 4, right?
It is.
That's better than fucking any LG track, dude.
Right.
Yeah, we've never given
especially
five
that track
LG
we have
track.
Called
actually we have
Die or Bullshit Artist because we got a bullshit artist on the track.
That is true. Horse shit.
Yeah, and we got a horse shit artist.
Penguin shit.
Me and Nate talked about doing a music video for that where we're all dressed up like with the pink sweaters and shit and the short shorts. Nate would have like a big old fucking white wig on.
Space you were fucking tour on Sturgeon Bay.
Space can have that little pig nose mask. Like,
you see that apartment up there? The first place Kiss ever put on their makeup at.
Yeah, we talked about
it
would be funny, wouldn't it?
I will. So I'll think about random scenes from that movie like throughout my fucking day, and like I'll just start busting out laughing. But the one scene that really fucking gets me laughing is that part where fucking what the fuck's the son's name, Brayden or whatever,
yeah,
yeah, where him and that girl are in the bed. Like, you know, she pulls her titties out. And he, like, goes to suck out of her or whatever. And she's like, I didn't say you could do that. Oh, man. Oh, man. I don't know why, man. That shit, that part fucked me up.
It's funny.
You know, like, I'll think about that part any fucking time of the day, man. I'll just start fucking laughing.
That was funny when there's a hootie tootie disco cutie and he's all upstairs stomping around trying to cover his ears.
Oh man.
Mars has yet to be indoctrinated by the Greasy Strangler.
It took Nate a year at least to get these motherfuckers to check that movie on.
Oh, yeah, I still can't see you guys, but fuck it. I hear y'all, motherfucker.
Hell yeah, hell good. Yeah. That's all.
Actually, Mars was in the movie, so I suppose he probably had to have seen it.
Jocko's like the Porto.
He's the guy.
Porto? What kind of chips are those? Porto? What? Porto?
What?
And then Mars is like, I think he's saying potato.
Looking potato.
Yeah, was that a real pig nose they made you wear, or was it just a costume?
Was it what?
Was it a real pig nose that you wore in that movie?
Just remember this conversation, and then when you watch that movie, The Greasy Strangler, brought to you by Jack Nussmonster.
All right, it's one of his productions? All right, sold.
It is one of his productions. He actually filmed that whole movie.
Oh, yeah.
It has that one singer on there, Maserati or whatever his name is.
Got share on that.
Yeah,
come on, bro.
That was good.
That was pretty good, dude. Yeah.
Oh, good. Pesto, I know you're one of the masters of impersonating motherfuckers. I mean, like,
I can bust out a good share if I'm in the fucking mood, bro. Okay, fucking. Yeah.
Yes, amen. Nice guys finish last, amen.
Yeah, hey.
That's a good Denku.
You don't know how to do this, dude. So it's best, and then you guys say, follow my lead.
No, here goes a good Denku right here. Fuck you like the worms crawling out of the dirt in the morning when it's fucking snowing outside. I come through with a number two pencil and I poke both your eyes and open wide and then you see inside my mind. That was like 4 out of 10.
You just gotta be like.
Yeah. That was 4 out of 10, though.
You gotta do it,
Dinkley. He would have took the words I just said and made him better, but. he'd just freestyle about random ass stuff, but it all just like fits together. Hell yeah.
Hell yeah.
Let me see what's in your pocket.
Hell yeah.
Let me see what's in your pocket, Mars. Let me try this.
Don't fucking encourage him, Mars.
Pulls out a fucking a big ditty.
Yeah, dude. Speaking of Mars One, yeah, dude. Do you want to? I mean, I don't know if you can because of the court shit, but can you give us a little bit of the behind the scenes of the Diddy case, being that you're so personally connected to it?
Since you're being sued and all.
You're a real
there's some rough accusations being thrown around about Mars One.
I hate you.
He was getting Mars Two'd.
What about Biggie, bro? You should be asking Biggie, motherfucker. Ask Biggie. Don't fucking ask me.
I saw that video of you and Cuban Pete in the hotel.
Oh, yeah, fist fighting?
Yeah, fist fighting. He was trying to go downstairs. And...
Yeah. Fucking hate
we saw that video last him, week of you getting punched in the back of the head by flames, yeah.
Yo.
Oh, yeah. By flames, rock. By flames, toddler, bro.
Flames, toddler. Dude, I was going to say, Nate, why don't you pull up just some random Cuban Pete track so we could Roast it.
I'm not gonna do that.
What is the one that you listened to that had the horrible bar? It was like him. Was that the song of him with Past One? Show us that song.
Just his verse.
Because you told me a bar and it was really bad, and I feel like you shouldn't spoil the bar, but you should send that song to Nate so that he can play it, and we can authentically enjoy it like you did.
All right.
What about that one where it was that one where he's like, "I'm not," or he's like, "I'm gay, but you think I'm homophobic?" Or...
No, it wasn't that. Just as bad.
Something like that.
Jesus.
I want to give an honest review, though. I think we've been kind of rough on Cuban Pete, so.
We'll give him a fair shake, just like I do every time I fucking use the urinal.
Yeah.
Give Cuban Pete a fair shake.
A fair shake.
I give my Cuban Pete a fair shake. Oh.
If you're shaking it more than twice, you're playing with it.
Bro, I'm always playing with it. Jace, you'll fucking appreciate. I have a gal that is at the bar that fucking like she's the anti-space in terms of her love for mayo. Like she gets it on everything. Surprise. Like shit that I'm like, you're putting mayo on that? She had me make her chicken strips and fries, and she's like, I was like, do you want any dipping sauce? And she's like, oh, just mayo, but I'll get it for myself. I was like, well, what do you want the like mayo for, the fries or the tenders? And she's like, both. And I was like,
fucking white people,
what, dude? Christ. So she got a big old thing of mayonnaise and she needed to get more. I was like, bro,
white people,
mayo is delish.
Mayo is good.
Hey, mayo's just, good, but like,
it's good on chicken.
Mayo's just better butter, dude. It's just better butter.
Yeah. No, I actually like Miracle Whip, but I don't really like mayo. I mean, I
bring out the Hellmann's.
Yeah, I don't mind.
Yeah, Hellmann's
mayo, I guess. It's just not. Yeah.
Miracle I don't Whip. Notice a fucking big difference between Miracle Whip and mayonnaise, to be completely honest with you.
I don't know what the hell. Bruh.
Dude, everybody's like got fucking strong opinions about the mayonnaise versus Miracle Whip debate, and I just am in the middle like, I don't give a fuck.
Can you tell the difference between Coca-Cola and Pepsi?
Yes.
Well, that's like Miracle Whip and mayo, man. Like, there's a definite
difference. There is a difference, and they're both fucking good.
There's a definite difference.
Yeah, I think maybe Miracle Whip is sweeter.
Dude.
They're both pretty cool.
Yeah, because, like, mayo is like...
Yo, I'm actually mad at you guys. Why are we having to talk about motherfucking mayonnaise and mayo in this bitch?
Because there's three white guys in this chat.
Mayonnaise and mayo? There's four white guys.
Four white guys. Right, do I count as two? Or?
No.
Yeah.
You do count
I think he's counting me.
Oh.
I was counting space. Yeah, I was counting space.
Five then. Count as two.
Space is just really tan.
Bump. I know six white people and you're three of them.
Jocko's my brother.
Jocko's my brother.
Jocko's my brother. Dude, Jocko, though.
Mars, did you send that song to Nate?
Dude, I can't even think of what fucking song, bro. Like, I'm trying to think. Like, I thought it was that one.
Was it the one with Past One? I thought that was the one.
Actually, maybe. I don't know. Hold on.
Past One is pretty dope.
He is dope, dude.
So, if we're gonna... We gotta just do...
Cuban Pete's verse.
I bet you could pick another Cuban Pete song and find a bar just as corny.
Bro, any fucking song from this fucking guy, you're gonna find some trash.
This is for our viewers out there. If you know who he is, tell him to unblock us and say what's up.
Homie literally was like, I didn't block anybody, and then jumped in my inbox, says, it's funny you think you matter, and then, like, he blocked me, and then made another post.
Okay, I
saying how he's never blocked funny. Anybody.
Oh, yeah, this is it. Okay, I know what you're talking about. Hold on.
I told him he sounded like Winnie the Pooh, and he blocked me. He didn't even entertain it. He just blocked me.
Another thing that you guys will also appreciate if this has happened to you. I don't know if it's happened to you yet or if you've made it in the underground. You haven't made it in the underground until fucking Kinetic 9 of Killer Army is fucking soliciting your inbox with fucking beats and features. And fucking, I see Pete fucking advertising a fucking song with...
Yeah,
Kinetic 9, bro. He got Pete, bro. He got him. I literally saw a status today by Words, like posting a screenshot of that dude in his inbox trying to solicit him and being like, "This is the corniest motherfucking bullshit I have ever been."
His response
to me like 4 years ago, and then unfriended me because I didn't.
Yeah, it wasn't his response. Eat a dick.
Yeah, his response was "fuck off."
Fuck off, yeah.
He tried selling me a fucking RZA beat, a parent RZA beat. I was like, "That's fucking hilarious."
Yo, I got a beat in the chamber though for Cuban Pete, and I already had a verse on it, and I got told not to drop it just yet.
That's
us.
Not what happened.
Pretty much. He blocked me, so it wouldn't even have been worth it. I'm waiting for him to unblock me so I can finish talking shit. Like, where was we? Oh, yeah, you remind me of Winnie the Pooh.
I got you shadow banned last time. Mars, you know where to send the song, right? It's in the side chat. It says review queue.
Oh, no. I got you right here, actually. Let's see. Oh, okay.
Come on, Mars. Man.
Yeah,
there we go.
Room is... oh, man.
You know, on, I had other shit to play so he can fucking send me this bullshit.
Yes, no, because this is
we need to wait.
This is important.
All right. Where the fuck? I mean, are we listening to the whole track? Are we listening to the whole track, like for real?
I mean, if you want to stop,
we'll do the hand thing.
I mean,
we'll do the hand thing.
Yeah, should we do the hand roll?
Yeah,
hand roll. So if as soon as you're like, all right, I'm tapping out, you put your hand up to the camera.
Yeah, I've heard enough.
It signifies that you've heard enough.
All right, but so, it's got to be at least three of us that do it.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't think that'll be an issue.
And then he gets a quick, salty review from us. Hey, you know what? I want to see him make a post like, oh, they made a whole podcast about me. It's fucking Yanks. I swear.
20 fucking episodes, right?
These fucking wankers.
Fucking jolly good. I fucking chip cheerio.
I ain't never eaten a crumpet in my whole life, son.
It's like, I mean, I fuck with past one.
Yeah, we fuck with past one. Let's just make that clear right now. Past one's dope. But Cuban
right.
Cuban. Yeah, for sure.
Bro, yeah, why is DW Underground on this?
Oh, DW Underground. Fucks with DW Underground too.
Yeah, it's probably a compilation thing though, because it doesn't look like he's actually. Oh, it's a DW Underground.
DW never told us about this. With Jabba the Cut on there too, damn. The fuck?
Hey. This is why I fucking hate Pete, bro. He's such a bottom feeder, bro.
Yeah, but, you know, I can't hold it against anybody that works with him, you know, because they don't all know the, you know.
They don't all know he's a piece of shit.
Yeah, they don't know.
Yeah, that dude's just bringing them business, you know. He do be sucking
mad dick of people, too, in their inbox.
Oh, for sure, bro.
Yeah.
So he's definitely...
Necklace.
see the spikes on my mic when I swing like a bat do. C75 in my blood, peep the tattoo. Coming at you like traffic through red lights. Chances are slim, want to win then you best fight. From shine stealers to life takers, I'm in between. I might lose your wife, pipe layer. Cry now, cry later. My mask off, I hate her, you rap soft. I eat MCs seasoned with bath salts. I can kick it, assholes get an assault. Control and delete clowns with beatdowns. Protect your neck, catch your head on the rebound. 3 points when I'm snapping your joints. Don't come back, you putting diss into support. Sit back, son, and play your role. Diss me and you best apologize, cause you're softer than coal. Bury you bastard. No man. Fuck you and yours, it's about me and mine. I snap your neck, in the end, I snap your neck. You be in danger, fuck over your whole style. The mama short challenge, drop real tricks, right rhyme. Corner store copping mad 40s and blunt raps. You stupid motherfuckers in the corner with dunce caps. Long Island Underground, know that I'll run that. Make it go boom like the sound of the gun clap. Skate shop where I get most of my threads from. Shine so bright, got me down when I rap rum. You don't got a reason for rapping, you should get one. Cause if you only do it for clout, you getting checked, son. Drug habit got me high as a kite. Eyes bloodshot like a fly through the night. You bitch made, man, you ain't the type of a fight. Be the type that would flee. Am I right or I'm right? I don't judge a book by the number of these sales, but you never get read like spam emails. They call me drunk, I usually be working the boards, making beats that you amateurs couldn't afford. Bury you bastard. No man. Fuck you and yours, it's about me and mine. I snap your neck, I snap your neck. You be in danger, fuck over your whole style. You should have took the sign. Coward, I don't play games, about to lose my mind. On the mic, I rain hell. Still they classified the vines. To the snakes, I hold my head high. Y'all slither without a spine. Take my time. I'm 36 and in my prime. There's a verbal documentary inside of a killer's mind. Before there was TikTok, they did it for the vine. Got all the shine at the lunchroom when I rhyme. Hard-headed, when I'm doing bad, I say I'm doing fine. I have nothing in common with a hater, I draw the line. People trying to buy my shine, but I shall decline. Out my mind, bolts in my neck like Frankenstein. I'm making time, waiting for things to fall in line. Couldn't stop my grind, you were working a sleeping line. Knew you were soft, the second I looked in your eyes. I'm here to cook, my Yelp rating's got $4 signs. Bury you bastard. No man. Fuck you and yours, it's about me and mine. I snap your neck, I snap your neck. You be in danger, fuck over your whole style.
See, I knew I was gonna like that song. I already forgot how whack this was. But it's getting an honest review.
Mars One tells us, wow.
Yo, Cuban Pete fucking ruins everything, son.
Yeah, he did. He did, actually. And he started it off, too, so it was just like, it was like taking a shit on the floor and then everybody else cleaning it up.
Yeah.
So Mars.
It was having like, it was like having a 3-course meal, but the fucking first course is a literal plate of shit.
Yeah.
Yeah, bro. It's like that motherfucker that started out really shitty and so he gets the best improved fucking award by the end of his fucking career. You know, because it's like, oh, most improved means that you fucking sucked when you started, and then the shit ended up pretty fucking dope. Not saying that Pete had any hand in making that shit dope.
Yeah.
He fucking actually soiled it.
Kind of jealous of the
beat. But Bass was dope, and then second dude was, you know, bowed down the road for me, I feel like, personally.
That first
what one, what's the line quotable for the Cuban Pete? I know what bar it was, but I don't have the quotable.
Something about being a pipe layer, bro. A certified wife pipe layer or something like that. I was like, come on, bro. Come on. Cuban Pete, can't even lie to yourself.
You know what stood out to me? Is that he makes all these posts like, oh, these wannabe white Wu-Tang fucking rappers. And then he's going to sit there and fucking like quote Wu-Tang in his song. Like, this is the second time I've heard him do it too, man. Like, it's just like, dude, you're the only fucking guy out here that's fucking trying to be the white Wu-Tang member, you fucking retard.
Yeah, bro.
He's like,
he's like, they all fucking think that they the RZA. I'm like, shut the fuck up, dude.
Honestly, like, probably one of the worst deliveries, like, on the same level of, like, Silk the Shocker, like, fucking bad. Like, I really, like, that's not even a fucking, like, and this is fucking cut the two different aside. Like, he's a fucking piece of shit to begin with. But I know pieces of shit that, like, okay, well, at least he's got this, or at least he's got that. And it's like, man, like, there isn't anything that really stands out with the wordplay or the bar work at all. And the delivery is so fucking off-putting and horrible. Like, from the vocal tone to the way that you even say shit is like, I kind of envy Helen Keller sometimes when I hear Pete's voice. I'm like,
right.
You know, it would suck to not be able to hear stuff. But you would also never have to know that treachery. So there is a silver lining to people that cannot hear, and that they never have to fucking listen to that shit.
And did I say he sounds
and I do,
like
I think
the
it
poo?
Was a. Yes, I do think it's a shame, because I do think, like, the beat was obviously DW's fucking nice with it. I thought that was a fucking dope beat. I think, like, Past One's verse was fucking pretty dope. I didn't really fuck with the delivery on that one a ton either. Like, I could tell, like, it was like he wasn't, like, super fucking excited to be on that track. It sounded like, I feel like, to me, the energy was he got a ref from Cube and Pete and then was like, oh, like, fuck, this can
be. He already paid me.
Yeah, yeah, he already paid me. I don't want to fucking send the money back. Like, all right, I'll do it. Because the content was dope. I wish there would have been just a little more energy. I know he's, like, kind of, it's how he is to some degree anyway, but I've definitely heard more energy than that. And then the last guy was all right. He just, he didn't, like, again, nothing really, like, fucking flew off the page to me. But he was okay. And Jabba the Cut, like, his fucking cut work is always fucking, dude, he'd be out here whirlwinding through titties, fucking crazy. You know, influential, scientifical titties. Fucking dropping the fucking bombs, bro. Like, he does nice, but, man, I'm just trying to think, like, if there is anybody, I don't think, man, even if one of y'all was at the end of that, I don't think it would have saved it for me. Because, like, I do have, like, a pretty strict, like, when I listen to collaborations, it's the same reason why, like, with Cypher sometimes, like, I don't replay a lot of Cyphers, because, like, if there is one verse in there that, like, makes me want to turn it off, then it feels like it's not worth my time. And, like, especially, like you said, with it being the first verse, it's not like I can listen to the song and then skip it when it gets to that. It's like I gotta fucking either go out of my way to, like, fast forward it past that if I want to listen to that song, and if I have to do that kind of work, it's like I'll just listen to something else. So
it's almost like that Mars One and who the fuck was on that
Conduit
track.
Yeah, dude, if we could have just had Conduit's verse, like
Akimbo
twice. Yeah, dude, that would have been sick, dude.
Yeah, bro, that would have been so much better, bro. That fucking track, right?
You reviewed that last week.
Oh yeah, you told me, you dickhead.
But hey,
so, Mars, you giving it a yes?
No, I'm giving it a no. I can't in good faith put something like that I genuinely would want to skip if I ever heard it come on the playlist.
So you could.
I give it a no track. Would have been dope. But
they would have just, you know, fucked off with the Cuban people that's done their own thing, you know, yeah.
Like, I could...
Yeah, I'm giving it a no as well, because that's how much Cuban Pete brought it down. Like, just, there's no other fucking way I can say it.
Like, I'd rather have...
Fuck, bro.
There's 100 1,000 Infinity Stones I'd rather put on that fucking track.
Jesus.
Oh, shit. Who that is?
Who that is?
Yeah.
Damn.
Cuban Pete. Why do you sound like Winnie
the Pooh? Yeah.
And not the Blood and Honey one either.
So I've listened to a few Cuban Pete tracks, and honestly, like this is the sharpest that I've heard him. This is probably like the most the most like into it that I've heard Cuban Pete. Like, he didn't sound nearly as bored on this track that he has on the other ones. So like I was actually kind of shocked. I was like, wow, Cuban Pete's getting into this one. But yeah, I don't know. Cuban, he's not my cup of tea, as Bumpin' would say that I say.
But
I guess I do say it. It's not my cup of tea, mate. I don't know who was second, because I thought the third dude was past one.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking too.
Yeah, the third dude is past.
Third one is.
I closed it as soon as it was done playing, because. Nah.
Yeah, you did the right thing.
Okay, that was the second guy that needed to fucking figure his fucking energy out.
His name is Young Link.
Yeah, he was Young Link.
Yeah, Young Link.
Because he sounded like... He definitely didn't sound like he wanted to be there either.
Well, he sounded heard like, Cuban Pete in the first verse and was just like, God fucking damn.
Right.
Maybe he was just like, hey, this is probably a low energy track. This is what he's going for. Maybe I should just like, you know, really bring my own level down.
He did just that. Yeah, the third verse was all right. I don't know. Honestly, I wasn't like super impressed with the third verse. Because, like, every time I've heard someone reference past one, like, everyone talks about how dope he is and shit like that. And maybe I'm just, I don't know, maybe the two previous verses narrowed my fucking interest. So it was like, I don't know. I don't know what the fuck happened. But the third verse, I'm not knocking the third verse. I'm not saying, like, it was complete garbage or anything like that. It just wasn't very impressive to me. The beat was dope. Job of the cut. Definitely did his fucking thing. Yeah. I would give it a no, though.
That's a yuck, bro. Yuck, bro. Yuck, bro. Yuck, bro. Yuck, bro. That Cuban Pete out of here.
Fucking yeah. Ugh.
That's ugh.
And, I had enough listening to Cuban Pete. Man, what was that, our third song, and we're an hour and...
Speaking of, with the Cuban Pete thing, because if Space would have said something about, like, yo, I was kind of feeling this or whatever, or like, I remember him getting physically angry the last time we had, like, a little get-together at his house, and I took his phone that was playing the Spotify, and I snuck a Cuban Pete track in there. He got, like, fucking pissed, bro, when that came on, dude. He was like, oh, what the fuck? Like, he was mad. Like, and not, like, joking, man. He was, like, actually angry. He was like, God damn it. It was fucking awesome. I was like, wow, that was even better.
Oh, it was not awesome. Cash. It's almost like someone's... Someone snuck fucking mayonnaise in between my fucking
$50 on your card or something.
The cheesecake and the crust or something. You know what I'm saying? Like, fucking assholes. Yeah, pesto.
Yeah, dude,
I forgot all about that shit.
This episode is brought to you by Jock Ness Monster Entertainment mayonnaise sandwiches. Coming to a city near you, the mayonnaise sandwich truck, piloted by Jocko's, my brother.
Warp, warp.
Warp, warp.
All right. Next up, we got a track submitted by Ivy Bumpin.
Swear to God, if this is what I think it is. Oh, okay. Some more garlic brown.
Oh, I almost thought Nate was trying to troll me. We got a track.
Dude, I thought he was going to tell me
the new RWC track.
Shut up.
You guys ready?
I've had enough mediocrity for tonight, man. Like, no more Cuban Pete's.
Yeah, no more Cuban Pete.
So many people are now departed. A walkie carcass, brain and heartless. Everyone's now a target. Is it the government pulling the string of the puppet and running the public? Or is it a bad joke from God here? Cause we be the butt of it. Apocalyptic end of days, hard to be optimistic. Cause they don't stop persisting, but we be forming a plot to twist it. They multiply and dying, but somehow alive and thriving. And they're gonna bite denying life, but we're gonna fight surviving. Some say it's man's fault, technology and asphalt. Consumers cash vaults, sprinkling food with bad salts. Either way it's a major pain, it don't matter who take the blame. Cause they eat up your brain the same, but we came to change the game.
Everywhere I turn my head all I can see is zombies. I try to get away but they always surround me. Followed by a zombie, bitten by a zombie, turn into a zombie. Everybody slow. Look at all these zombies, I can't get them.
There's nothing but zombies, no way to escape, but I gotta stay brave. Still hoping and praying we can save the day. I'm blaming the radio waves for the way to behave. It's like they're insane, our brain is becoming the same. Affecting each other, decaying the brains. No wonder the numbers are going to shame. But I never surrender, too clever to make a mistake and get late. Gotta be ready to pick up the pace. No matter the memory, look at them now. Another victim looking up in the crowd, searching for people and grabbing them down. About the way to populate to write out. Unless we can stop this apocalypse, put it back in the ground. I'll try that the remedy's found. But staying alive and not losing my mind is a difficult time. That never could try, but neither do I. We gotta survive, no matter what dies. It's already minutes of mine. Swing at the plague and we got the prevailing vibe. So we stick to the plan we devise. Push it forward, never looking behind. But
everywhere I turn my head, all I can see is zombies. I try to get away, but they always surround me. Followed by a zombie, bitten by a zombie, turn into a zombie. Everybody slow. Look at all these zombies, I can't get them.
Even though they heart don't beat, they still bleed. Even though they lungs don't breathe, they still scream. They're fighting our people, but don't have the stomach for beef. The friends of the weak and lacking on speed. But they're thinking numbers, remember these zombies are like a disease. Eventually creeping up to believe. See, we inevitably clean the scene. Whoever they be, please believe they'll never defeat these three. Whenever we meet, we're several with these. They're losing their heads and retreat. Flipping the streets and we're not gonna stop till the mission's complete and the dentist can beat. Wherever they sleep, definitely coming to fall some fatal times. They'll eat your brain if you pay no mind. Gotta decide your side. Either you win or you lose, you live or you die. But there's something worse than death. Living here with no purpose left. But you about to learn to bet. We ain't even scraped the surface yet.
Everywhere I turn my head, all I can see is zombies. I try to get away, but they always surround me. Followed by a zombie, bitten by a zombie, turn into a zombie. Everybody slow. Look at all these zombies, I can't get them.
Holy fuck, bro. Okay, so I picked that track because they were shooting a video for it and me and Nate were in it.
and they had like a bunch of motherfuckers from the bars all dressed up like zombies, and we were shooting a video for it like all night, and then the footage was just lost, so it never had a video come out for it. But there's an ad for the video on YouTube. But it's a good song, and I played it, and my daughter listens to it, and now she's always like, can you play the zombie song? She always wants us to play that song. It's a pretty good song. So,
I liked the song. I liked the song.
You go next, Mark.
So, like, the song, you know, it was just some honest music, you feel me? Like, zombies, good fucking topic, you feel me?
Yeah.
You know, can't really go wrong with that shit. And then, like, the flow was solid, I liked the singing. He got some good tonality in his voice, and, you know, I think that, like, the MC matched the beat selection, so that was also a plus. Hell yeah. Fuck yeah, I say yes on this motherfucker. Why not, oh, right? I mean, I didn't see anything really negative about it, like, it wasn't, like, mind-blowing. It's not like it, like, fucking blew my mind. But I don't think that shit was meant to blow my mind. I think it was meant to kind of serve a purpose of, like, you know, nice hip-hop vibe, pretty modern vibe, and it gets my approval.
Hell yeah.
I got no
so it's kind of, it's kind of funny because the first guy, like, there's two of the MCs reminded me of, like, so the second guy is, like, in my brain, I was just like, this is who Noxus is trying to be. Every track, like, that guy just, like, never breathed. Like, there was one point in his verse where I was like, okay, there's a spot to breathe. But everything else was just, like, but it was done really well. Like, he clearly had the chops for it, and he, like, if he, I'm sure he didn't do it all in one fucking layer. Maybe he did, but it's, like, no. I think that he,
yeah,
he probably laid.
He does that.
I'm just going to say this. He is a fucking freak of nature with breath control.
And it's really right, hard and I'm not to mix his possible. Verse, too. Because, like, he did that over at my studio. And he did his whole verse in one, and it was all chopper. And, I wasn't listening to the beat. It wasn't this song. It was a different one. But I wasn't, like, listening to the beat or anything. He just had me throw it up and throw the headphones on and get to the spot where he was at. And then he recorded. And I'm sitting there just, like, trying to picture how the beat sounded. And he just chop it like that. How did that sound? And I was like, pretty dope, man, but I don't know how the beat sounds, so.
It sounded.
It sounded. Yeah, I was like, I couldn't figure out how the beat sounded or anything. And
well, and then the first MC kind of reminded me not as much stylistically, but more so with like his vocal patterns and his delivery of like Mars One, but like much younger, like a younger, like a fucking 14-year-old, like adolescent Mars One, like way less deep tonality, but some of the flavor. It just kind of reminded me of like the way Mars says some things, and that just kind of made me chuckle of like, This is we got Mars One here, and this is Mars Sun over here.
Like, you're gonna have to do that, like, no matter if it's like a whack review or a dope one, just be like, yeah, it reminds me very much of Mars delivery, like, especially on like the Infinity.
Yeah, version. the guy didn't really, he didn't really show up. Kind of reminds me of Mars.
Yeah,
it kind of reminds me.
But no, I thought it was a solid track. It wasn't like, it didn't like blow me away. I mean, the chopping was really, really well done. Chopping isn't really my thing that I really like. I don't get into chopping as much, but I always appreciate when somebody does something like incredibly well. And I think all three of the MCs did a fucking great job. I thought the hook was creative. It wasn't like that. Also, didn't like blow me away. But I like to hear a little bit of a difference. Like, I like to hear it kind of get slowed down. It kind of gave a good parody to the track. So I'll also give that a yes.
Well, you know me. I did not like the song. definitely, you know, give credit where credit's due. Like, they were all definitely good at what they did. You know, Garlic Brown,
He always comes with some fucking quality production. And the MCs were pretty good, man. I don't know. The hook really lost me. I think it's because, so my eldest daughter, Vivian, has been on this kick where, like, she's listening to songs from, you know, like, all her, like, borderline horror cartoons and shit like that. And, like, this is kind of what that reminded me of. And I mean, like, this track, I don't know, this track's got some quality. It's sort of the tracks that she fucking listens to as well, but, like, it's just, I don't know, it's hard for me to take this track seriously, and I think, like, that's part of the reason why. Plus, like, Zombies, I don't know, man, Zombies, it's not even the fact that they're played out. It's like, I don't know, for Zombies to be effective in any way, like, it has to be scary to me. And it's like, whenever Zombies aren't, like, I don't know, whenever they don't have that, like, scary feel, like, it's just cheesy shit. I don't know. Those are some reasons why I don't really care for this track. So, with that being said, I'm gonna give it a no. Not that it fucking matters, you know. But, still, that's me.
I do feel you on that, being like, the videos the kids watch these days and they have those songs, because my kids all listen to shit like that. But this song came out like in 2000, or it was made like in 2014 or 13 or something like that. And, that was before all those songs came out. But now that you say that, that's probably why my daughter likes that song so much.
Right. Probably. Yeah. And I mean, like, I understand the draw, you know what I'm saying? And like I said, like everything about this song is done pretty fucking well. It's just not my shit. Plus, we just listened to Cuban Pete reference eating bath salts, you know, to season something in his fucking verse the song.
Oh, yeah, he did say this.
And then the fucking dude in the first verse. Some bath salts. Yeah, and the dude in the first verse had to say the same thing, too. So, I don't know. I'm starting to fucking...
Around that time, it was, like, new when that fucking dude smoked bath salts and ate that person's face. So,
it was a Halloween theme song, too. I should have mentioned that, too.
Like, yeah, I mean, this isn't my favorite song by them, but I did like what everybody...
Yeah, I mean, you guys don't have to defend them. You know, it's just...
I ain't gonna. I'm just giving my review, too.
Yeah.
Fuck.
No, I feel you, though.
Yeah, this isn't my favorite song by them, so that's a no for me.
A million times because of my daughter. And it was just one of the...
I dig the verses. I think the hook was too much.
I liked the hook because... You know, Demo's a really good singer for one, and for two, Cleo loves that part, and she sings it all the time. We have to sing along. But that's just for nostalgic reasons, but, like, man, I've been hearing, like, the YouTube songs they've been listening to, and it's just like,
Fuck that talk.
On repeat.
Yeah, I let them make their own Spotify playlist. So when we go, when I bring them to school, pick them up from school, basically when we go anywhere, I put on their playlist. Luckily, they let me add some songs too. So it's like, I got some songs that I think that they might enjoy a little bit. Some that I don't really care.
Maybe Winnie the Pooh songs.
Oh, fucking Cuban Pete. It's like, you know, there's some fucking drum and bass on there. There's some hip hop. I got fucking Dumb by Styles of Beyond on there. You know, fucking.
Oh, you need to start.
What's that?
You need to start indoctrinating Maisie with, like, Feral Monch and shit.
Yeah, she's not quite ready for all that. I mean, she's heard some of that shit, you know, but, like. like today, you know, Check Yourself by Ice Cube came on, and Maren wanted to skip it, and fucking
Yep.
And then so she ended up skipping it, and fucking both Vivian and Maisie were pissed. They were
oh hell yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
It's like so, that, I mean, though.
We're doing pretty good. You know what I'm saying?
I don't understand the draw to, like, the new age music stuff. And then not just the draw to that, but then also to be, like, you know, anything that's old is whack, kind of. So it's just my kids be.
Actually, now that you mentioned that, like, there was a, I saw a post that Lupe Fiasco's got a project coming out soon. And there was somebody in there saying, like, it's gonna be fucking old head energy garbage, blah blah blah. And thankfully he got torn to absolute shreds by people being like, yo dude, like what the fuck, that's the energy that you're talking shit about and you're projecting it onto these other people, like on this dude's what? Fucking post about his art, like
yeah,
like what you want to like, but like I do think that just not like respecting other people's right to like what they fucking like is kind of weird, because it's like a lot of the times it doesn't affect you what somebody else is listening to, unless like it's in a situation like you guys are in where you got your kids and you're directly affected by, you know, classic bangers getting skipped in lieu of fucking Baby Shark song.
Yeah,
right. Oh no, not Baby Shark.
Yeah, so not Baby Shark, like, but
she listens to like, oh man, what's that shit? I think it's called like the Money Song by fucking, I don't remember. And there's this fucking Doja Cat song that she's fucking into. Oh man, yeah. This fucking stupid, you know, this shitty, shitty, low quality fucking mumble rap track that she's fucking into, and it's like. Oh man, it's so fucking stupid, dude. I don't understand this shit. Cause like the track, not only does dude rapping sound like shit, but like the song itself sounds like shit. And I mean, like it's a modern fucking hit. You know what I'm saying? It's not on the radio because it's too vulgar and whatnot. But like, you know, she must have heard the shit on. I don't even know where the fuck she heard it. But I mean, it's a hit on fucking Spotify. You know what I'm saying? Like it's. Oh man, it's disappointing as fuck, dude.
Yeah. These damn kids are listening to their Who's You Watch.
But I got that fucking Apathy track, the fucking the pirate one. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, check. The fucking Don't Give Up the Ship or something like that.
Yeah. And they're all fans of that one. So, I mean, you that's know, we have some. Right. We do have some common ground. But...
Hell yeah. It's
the worst.
I do remember, actually, it's kind of funny that you mentioned Apathy, because I remember, so, when we first met, like, we talked a little bit, but we never really hung out where, like, we're playing music or anything like that. And I had been in the hospital, and I think I told you already when I was in the hospital, I listened to the Not What You Think Project, and I listened to God Particle Project by, or like that song in particular a lot. So then when I went to the first night when you guys were playing Ho out at, in Brussels, and I went out there and you were playing Army of the Pharaohs, I was like, all right. Like, sick, man. Like, I didn't know if you, like, I didn't know what your fucking knowledge, how deep your knowledge was, if you were into the obscure stuff or if you were into more mainline shit. I didn't really know. So I was like, damn, sick. Like, these guys like fucking dope shit that's like not necessarily because it's fucking popular, but just because it's dope. So it was kind of a cool, like, I'm in the right fucking place moment where I was like, hell yeah. But then, unfortunately, and I'm glad that Mars One is here for this, because I don't think I've ever really made the official announcement to a lot of people, because it's not really worth announcing, but it's always fuck Vinny Paz. He gets one of these fucking emojis right here that'll fucking pop up. Yeah, he gets one of those. Cause,
his screen is actually...
Yeah.
Well, talking back to, like, what we were talking about before with, like, people skipping shit and whatever. Like, Mars gave his opinion, and it wasn't even a fucking, like, harsh criticism by any means. Like, I think Vinny had posted something about a dude in his camp, and Mars was like, yeah, dude, this guy's, like, pretty dope. I like his style and his delivery. I just wish the content was a little bit more, like, not as much about, like, glorifying the street life kind of thing. And Vinny didn't give him a fucking inch. Just immediately full bore. You are a faggot nerd pussy. Bitch,
I just said that, like, it seemed like a little recycled. You know what I mean? That's all. And I know that sounds dick, but it was like, it was just a fucking opinion, bro. I wasn't trying. It was like everyone was flipping their wig over this guy's verse. And it's like, I was like, it was dope and everything. The dude's obviously fucking skilled, but it just seems like a little kind of recycled material. And they fucking, like, went off. And then Stu Bangas, I hope that you fucking see this one day, you big fucking steroid taking avin ass little fuckboy. I don't mean to talk shit, but this dude fucking blocked me just because I got in an argument with Vinny Paz over this shit. And then Vinny Paz comes to my inbox fucking talking shit. It looked like a fucking bunch of fucking fourth graders fucking talking shit to each other, like, no, you're a bitch. No, you, no, your mom. Like, fuck you, Vinny Paz, you fat bitch.
Dude, it's funny because Mars is, like, one of my favorite things about Mars, because, like, I talk to him pretty frequently, so I get to hear about, like, his day-to-day sometimes and his interactions with people in the public. Like, he gives no quarter. When somebody fucks around with Mars, they find out. Like, when he was at Dollar General, like, you guys saw the video where he got punched and then he's, like, hiking up the pants. But there was, there's a litany more of videos of, like, him, like, fucking just tearing somebody's ass. Like, in public.
Like this
just,
video,
like,
right here.
Calling somebody. Yeah, I mean, we could find more. Like, yeah, he just, like, he would send me videos sometimes of, like, him filming somebody walking out of his store with a bunch of shit and being like, yeah, you fucking pussy bitch. Like, he'd say some, like, real direct insults about their clothes and stuff. Like, he's fucking, dude, just, like, fucking unhinged in the best way. It was like, dude, that's
damn. Fuck, I gotta, dude, send some of that shit over. We gotta make a compilation, bro.
Yeah, that vigilante justice Mars, bro. He's just, like, straight up. Or, like, the other day, too, I think there was, like, somebody, he's like, I almost fucked somebody up in traffic today. He said some shit like that. Like,
he's like the Batman, like, of Dollar General. It's fucking,
he's one of the people that when they say, like, I almost fucking went off on this motherfucker, that, like, I know for a fact that, like, there was actually somebody almost got fucking torn apart. Because, like, I've heard it, I've seen it, like, Mars don't fuck around like that. And it's like, I love that fucking energy. But, like, to the fucking point that we were talking about with that particular situation, I think, like, it was, like, because, like, he was in fucking Mars's inbox for an entire day. Like, just, like, being really, really petty about it. And I think Mars even at one point just tried to, like, extend the, like, yo, dude, like, I respect your opinion and I respect you coming to fucking bat for your people, like, no fucking ill will towards you, man. Like, I'm just kind of over this kind of situation. And Vinny fucking doubled down. He was like, no, fuck you, bitch. Like, he just did not fucking accept at all any kind of mutual respect. And that, to me, I thought was, like, pretty fucking grimy and shitty and, like, kind of a bitch move. Cause it's,
you,
like,
know what's legendary, though? Is that I have a message from him. I'm going to use it, like, if I ever have to diss him for any type of reason. It's just a message of him in my inbox, and he's saying, would you please, please get on the new Jedi Mind Tricks album? Let me
know. Yeah, he said that.
Like, fucking clown bitch, dude. He's just an asshole, like, that, you know? And I know
he's like, I need you to legitimize myself.
Yeah, I thought that was fucking great, though. Like, oh, you're asking me? Oh, very good. No, how about no? I'm a little busy working on Cuban Pete feature.
I think it was like weird egotistical baiting where he was like, this dude probably rides my dick so hard that if I ask him to get on my project, even though I've been in a fight with him, he's going to immediately jump to it. And then I'm going to be able to dunk on him super hard, not knowing that, like, you have self-respect. And, like, I think we all kind of have the same opinion where it's like, yeah, there's, like, people out there that have done shit in the fucking industry and made fucking moves and shit that are dope, but, like, there ain't nobody that's fucking anywhere in it that I would fucking just work with because I'm like, I fucking need to work with this person. Like, the person's a piece of shit. Like, I don't give a fuck. Like, I honestly, I think, like, the team that we're on is fucking every bit as, has every bit as much potential to be dope. And people are already, like, that fucking dope to me. Like, listening to the fucking camps tracks and in our affiliated camps, the God Division fucking guys, the fucking Cyphodin Brotherhood, you know, like, fucking people like that, like, Hutch. Like, there's a lot of fucking allies that we've linked up with, and it, like, got to the point where it was like, man, I know a lot of people that are actually making music that, like, not just because I'm fucking friends with them and I like these people and I know them, but it's like, man, I like the music. Like, the music is actually really fucking good. And, like, that's incredibly cool. And I think it's a testament to, like, man, there's a lot of fucking dope rappers out there. And, like, to me, that's not enough if I, like, as far as collaboration or anything like that goes. Like, you got to be a fucking dope person, too. You got to be cool. Like, I don't want to just work with people because they're dope, because I know fucking four dope motherfuckers right here. I know fucking DW. I know fucking all, like I said, all those people. It's like, man, we know so many fucking dope people that are dope.
Wait, hold on. As people. But there's five of us with you.
Hey, I did.
I said these four. I'm the fifth.
I got dope joints. I sent in a submission. Do I get a submission too?
You submitted that Kevin Pete track. That's
Kevin Pete song.
No, not that Kevin.
Yeah, fucking so yeah, you're cut off, man. You're cut off.
Yeah, that was so good.
Here's I got Mars baited, bro. Second. That was my submission. I would have made it fucking worth it.
Here's Mars' right second what submission. Fuck?
What is double this? Down. Is this Mars' second submission?
He put this in the review queue.
Okay.
Yeah, I get this. Hello.
This track right here?
Yeah, this track right here. You guys are going to
enjoy the here.
Why don't you don't know about shoes, tell him who it is?
Yeah, I was going to say those shoes or something else.
This is motherfucking LB, a.k.a. Legendary Baller, a.k.a. Lot of Bitches, a.k.a. Lima Beans. You fucking feel me? The fucking granddaddy motherfucking Fisciando Mac Daddy motherfucking from Chicago. All right? Enjoy.
All right.
Fuck bro.
Fuck bro. What an intro.
The good folks at Team 10 and Piranha Mind Record would like to say peace to the legendary Eric B. Peace to the god Raquel. I hope you approve.
What you
I ain't gonna give them nothing but some uncut ism. Women of all colors, the rainbow coalition. And when I give them the ism, they be playing their position.
What you
I ain't gonna give them nothing but some uncut ism. Women of all colors, the rainbow coalition. And when I give them the ism, they be playing their position. I can turn shit to sugar. I can pick a hooker like a booger. Under pressure, I become a pressure cooker. If the thigh is cute, I got a shot to shoot. I stays in hot pursuit of a prostitute. That's when I look up and down. It's your past inspection. All she needs now is daddy's direction. A real pimp position is provide protection. Pass the weight around like a church collection. When I hits the scene, it gets the green. Hot and ready like Krispy Kreme. I'm Mr. Mean. What rules everything around me? It's the cream. All hail the king. Bow, kiss the ring. Bling, bling, don, dada. Room at the Ramada. The way I'm stacking the cheese, you can call me Ricotta. On the microphone, ain't another Mac Hotter. I'm cool as ready. Boom, boom. Welcome back, Cotter.
What you
I ain't gonna give them nothing but some uncut ism. Women of all colors, the rainbow coalition. And when I give them the ism, they be playing their position.
What you
I ain't gonna give them nothing but some uncut ism. Women of all colors, the rainbow coalition. And when I give them the ism, they be playing their position. I'm the L-I-M-A to the boogity beans. If I wasn't, then why would I look so clean? My hair is soft, my fat is so pristine. Even my car's a killer, I call that bitch Christine. I say my Mac is the meanest, my Cadillac is the cleanest. I never travel with luggage, cause I'm packing some penis. So all that huffing and puffing and bluffing's really for nothing. My contribution to prostitution, don't even discuss it. I can't be tempted by temptation, David Ruffin's my cousin. She wanna see if the thing is hanging, I told her to touch it. And then I put in the tip, and the girl started gushing. I said, your name ain't Patrice, mama, why is you rushing? I turn a diamond to dollars, and turn a dollar to dubs. So if I ever catch a case, I can pay off the judge. I keep a straight razor with me when I come in the club. I cut them so quick, don't even gotta wipe off the blood. Let's go.
What you
I ain't gonna give them nothing but some uncut ism. Women of all colors, the rainbow coalition. And when I give them the ism, they be playing their position.
What you
I ain't gonna give them nothing but some uncut ism. Women of all colors, the rainbow coalition. And when I give them the ism, they be playing their position.
Beatles. Fucking steal my moves, bro.
That song had big, nasty Nate C energy. I'm just gonna
say
that right
now. Dude, he was doing the fucking pesto at the end. Yo, Mars, give us the behind the scenes on why you chose that track.
Well, just because I think that, like, more of the world should know about this dude. I think he's fucking funny, and he's dope. And, like, it's like an alter ego, so he's another MC. And, like, yeah, the dude's just fucking hilarious. And he has a bunch of dope content, so it's just, like, plugging. Because he's actually got some dope bars, and he just dropped two albums this year, and, like, featuring, like, Big Daddy Kane and Big Boy from Outkast and some other. It's on some just totally Macadelic pimping shit. What? It's super hilarious, and the bars are actually, like, worth checking out.
Hell yeah.
Also, it's a classic legendary beat that he rocked over, and, like, I think that he's, like, one of the few people that did it justice in that way without just, like, doing it distasteful. He brought his own flair to it, and it was dope.
I agree. I dude, that, yeah, that song was fucking hilarious. Like, I've seen him before. I've definitely seen some of his content. I don't think I haven't seen this song before.
Yeah.
But yeah, dude, he's got some fucking bar work, bro. Like, his wordplay is fucking incredible. Like, it reminds me, he's got, like, Big Red Man vibes, but with, like, kind of more of the classic, like, Big Daddy Kane flow. And it's like, such man, like, his punchlines are so fucking hilarious. And, like, just, like, some of the shit he be saying is, like, very, very out there. But I think, like you said, he's got the alter ego, so it fucking works. Like, it's very, like, there's a lot of people that do the gimmick thing that, like, don't, like, they do the gimmick thing to, like, kind of fuck off and, like, not put the same kind of effort and energy into, like, making the content good. They're like, I'm just going to be funny. But, like, I really appreciate that he, like, not just grabbing the low-hanging fruit, because he could probably blow up just as fucking big by, like, just being the character and not bringing as dope a content as he does. But it's like, man, I got mad respect. Like, the hook was fire, the fucking verses were fire, the song was both hilarious and, like, hard as fuck. Like, dude, like, he was fucking spitting like a motherfucker, dude. Like, that dude was snapping. Like,
dude,
I fucking like it. Like,
everything he puts out is, like, on that pedigree too, just warning everybody. He's, yeah, really worth, like, listening to. It's fucking hilarious.
Yeah, like, the other stuff that I'd heard from him too, like, was like, bam, this guy's fucking silky with it. Like, he's got a fucking jam, and, like, it does fit the fucking the pimp fucking aura and his fucking delivery, like, particularly, like, in the hook, you heard it a lot, like, his vocal flavor, where he's just like, the Rainbow Coalition, yeah, like, he's got, like, that Cat Williams pimp flair voice in his shit, and it's like, it's so fucking awesome. Like, it's like, man, like, that's some fucking good shit. Like, I definitely give that a yes. I really enjoyed it.
I'm glad you like that shit. I'm glad you like that shit.
Nate Nasty.
They're gonna call me in a second.
Yeah, I mean, at first, like, his whole get up, I was like, what the fuck is this? Then, like, that flow just fucking, it blew my fucking mind over here. Yeah, man, that shit was pretty dope. I'm gonna give it a yeah. Like, I couldn't tell if he was, like, if those were for real his teeth and he was just, like, about it. But you guys keep saying it's, like, a gimmick or an alter ego thing. But no, I fucking believe that this is that dude. So
yeah, like, he puts out videos that's, like, him, the real, like, the other version of him, like, his real MC self. His name's Sawbuck. It's, like, Sawbuck. And he, like, battles himself as LB. So it's, like, LB versus Sawbuck. There's, like, four of them. Bro, that shit, we would die laughing. If you guys got time, like, I'll fucking send him in there, you know? Even just the first one, you guys probably saw a portion of.
Bro, that's crazy, because that's definitely, like, something I want to do in the future is, like,
totally different ego, like, a different,
yeah,
character. Yeah.
Yeah, Rap Shitty versus Pestilence, bro. Rap Shitty and Bohemus.
Bohemus.
Dude, Bohemus is a great name.
Yes. What do you think, Space?
man, I thought it was dope. Yeah, this is somebody I've seen something from him before, and like the last I feel like it was fucking years ago. And I, you know, somebody posted it. It probably said something like this: "This old man snaps" or some shit like that. And yeah, like I don't know, man. He's dope. He's dope as fuck. Like it's just, dude. It's just bar after bar after bar, and. Yeah, I don't know, man. He fucking rocked it, dude. And that old school beat too, man. Like, I love that shit. I love that shit. And yeah, like he has everything above an old school flow, you know. Like Pesto said, you know, it fucking even like the tonality of his voice and all that shit. Yeah, dude, he fucking killed it. I'm a fan. Yeah, I'm definitely now that I know the name, now that I know that this is something real, I definitely wanna fucking being more into this because I'm intrigued. And I remember being intrigued too when I heard it the first time, but like it was just like somebody posted it almost as like a, you know what I'm saying? And it wasn't a whole song, I think it was just like the first. But yeah, this is dope. I like that shit. Had me fucking smiling the whole damn time, dude. What about you, Bumpin?
It's my turn. Hold on, you guys. Yeah. Holy fuck!
I didn't mean to bother you, man.
Just took a big rip and fucking. What you think, Bump? Hold on 1 second.
He's over there. Just that was dope.
Yeah. No, that song was fucking dope. I thought that was Pesto without his mask.
Damn.
I never saw LB and fucking Pesto in the same room. Nah, but that had big Nate Nasty vibes. Like I could picture Nate making a song exactly like that and being
straight up. Fucking voice on that shit.
I thought it was pretty dope.
Just for that, I'm putting your next fucking request all the way back.
We're coming up over 2 hours now, so I was gonna say
I think that's actually a good one to end on.
Yeah, that was a good one to end on.
Hey, let's end it on the battle. Let's end it the last one, boys. For clear context, since LB clearly the winner of the night.
So you're saying
I'm
a winner of the night, feeling make people feel fucking excluded.
That's like, not how it works.
Well, we do it. We could. I actually don't dislike the idea of nominating and voting on like a favorite track of the night going
forward. Yeah, I think that'd be dope.
I think that's kind of
Putting those into a playlist and then maybe like doing an episode about all of them, like which one's our favorite or something. I think that'd be cool.
Yeah, like a best of the best at the end of the year. That could be cool.
Yeah. Like it's just an idea, you know?
Right before March Wackness.
Yeah, bro.
Or just right after, as a palate cleanser, like right afterwards. Because yeah, I think should do it the week after as like an appreciation. Just have like fucking boom. And it's funny because March Wackness we could do the last week of March and then have the fucking like the serious like the good hearted one be on like the fucking April Fool's week.
I almost feel like now we should take the wackest one of each night and fucking that could be a March Wackness bracket.
We can do both.
Yeah, I actually like that. We could start doing that and that's how we build the next March Wackness. That's a good concept.
Dude, did they ever hit you back about getting their $4?
No, they did not.
Damn.
I don't think they ever looked at it, responded, nothing. So.
They're missing out, man.
Well, I mean, like, I looked
at... You're lost, motherfucker.
I looked at Catholic's page, and, like, he seems like a very strange individual. Like, I think he's, like, in South America. He's in some fucking weird part of the world. He's in some weird part of the world doing, like, I mean, like, I've seen, like, there was one outfit that looked like he was wearing, like, a priest robe or some shit. He's, I don't know, man. He's living an interesting life. There's no doubt about that. So, and, I mean, yeah. Who could expect anything less from the official winner of the first annual Fuck Bro March Wackness tournament, Gasolic.
I know. He'll
forever be immortalized. Like the green and gold.
The first of the first, NFL. Bro. He's one of the best ever to do it, bro.
That's the first, bro. You know, one of the coldest in the game.
If anybody could win it, man, I'm glad it was him.
Real. Yeah, he led the way, bro. He had what it took.
Bro, humble in victory, humble in defeat. He didn't say a goddamn word the whole time. He was one of the only ones that didn't.
I listened to, like, at least, like, five times as many songs.
Oh, my
than
God.
What was featured.
To be fair, I also listened to probably an additional, like, 9 or 10. I just never did the footwork of, like, I was like, oh, man, these, I'll go back and, like, yeah, find out who these are. And fucking, so then I was just like, shit, we're getting too close. Nate just fucking throws some songs, throws some disappears on there. And he's like, I've already gone through them. I gave a bit of my soul in the fucking hunt for the worst.
It wasn't like, my soul, it was my sanity.
Yeah, it's just like, oh, a piece of me left. And it's like, yeah, I don't know. I think, like, there is
and now I wait for you.
Few things that we can fucking laugh about going back on the fucking podcast. That was, like, from start to finish, the initial concept, the idea, the execution, the tournament. One of my favorite times we've ever had so far. Because, like, that whole night, for as bad as the music was, I had a great time.
Dude, the execution was
it was so fun, bro. That was so fucking fun.
This shit
fun.
Was prime.
It was so funny to just sit back and, like, be like, God damn. Because it is, like, you can be the dopest motherfucker in the world. I think everybody has those moments where you're like, man, I don't know if I got it in me. And then you hear that, and you're just like, damn, I got it in me. This motherfucker, holy shit. Holy shit.
That's fucking hilarious, bro.
Fucking complaining about my fucking ability and just fucking execute. Like, holy shit, this is not even close.
That's fucked, oh, bro.
It's true, though, dude. You can't tell me that you don't have that a little bit. It's like you have a little bit of, like, you hear, like, an Infinity Stone, and you're like, all right.
Could be me.
At least, especially, like, it's probably, because, like, you're in an area of the country, Mars. Like, I was only down there for a few months, but it seemed like that part of the country was, like, a lot more accepting to alternative lifestyle in general, like just people doing obscure things, pursuing art, stuff like that. Like,
yeah, because it's still like
human. In particular, is like a small, fucking kind of redneck yuppie town that, like, there's a great fucking music scene there for how small that town is and how political and weird that town is, but, like, outside of, like, the people that are just, like, artists themselves or, like, just fucking part of the fucking fam and, like, supporters of, like, the fucking live music, which is a pretty decent population, pretty much everybody else that lives there is, like, the attitude of, like, the, don't listen to that, rap is crap. Like, that's the fucking...
Yeah.
So it is, like, kind of one of those things where you're, like, you do, I mean, at least I know I have had a lot of that, like, fuck, especially because my family was not accepting of fucking hip-hop at all. So it's like, that was something that I was always like, I don't want to fucking bring great dishonor and shame upon my family. But then, like, I hear an Infinity Stone, and I'm like, I ain't bringing shame upon shit. There's motherfuckers out here doing this. Like, and their family, like, fucking is like, yo, dude, kill it, bro. Like, my family could just shut the fuck up and be grateful that I'm not doing that.
You guys did it figured out. It's good you're wearing a fucking bird mask and dancing like a fucking penguin having a seizure in the fucking corner of the venue.
I'm
on fucking happy feet.
You went right in the fucking middle of fucking front and center stage, motherfucker.
Well, I'm talking about because a lot of times we perform in the corner of the venue.
That is true.
You got no choice. Yeah. I don't know why I just rewind that show. Stuck in my brain instantly.
What was the rewind? Where is that one? Is that the Sheboygan one? Yeah, the Sheboygan venue. That was a cool venue, but like, what a fucking weird crowd, bro. What a weird crowd. The only thing I didn't like about that venue was the fucking gigantic fucking monitor they had strapped up, like, on the ceiling. I was like, that ceiling? That's going to kill somebody. Like, if that those anchors fucking cut, like, somebody's going to die. That's not going to be like a, oh, you broke somebody's arm. Like, you are going to flatten a motherfucker with that. That thing is, like, several hundred pounds.
Yeah, yeah. It'll happen. Yeah, like, we'll hear about it.
Bro, I was watching it the whole time. I was like, on that Final Destination really fucked up a whole generation of people into thinking, like, just the time when they see something like that, your brain's just like, not today, motherfucker. Not today. You ain't gonna catch me standing under that shit. Fuck you. And every time, like, the employees had to keep walking through that alleyway, and I'm just, like, picturing like, each one of them. I'm like, it's gonna happen. Oh, sorry. Bye, Gary. You're dead. You're about to get flattened by that. And it never happened, but I'm like, one day, bro. Maybe it wasn't today, but one day. It's going to fucking happen. And you're right. We're going to fucking hear about it. Everybody's going to hear about it, dude. That happens. It's going to change the world. What was that noise?
What do we got? We got one more? What is this?
What? All right, where's the video at?
Round Saltbuck won the coin toss. Wait, the beast. Can't wait to see the outcome between these two titans. No cap.
So, Bump, are you ending the recording then? Because you're the one that's recording, right? Bump.
Bump. You got 3 minutes, Bump? 3 minutes.
Let's get it popping!
Oh, it's going down, boys.
Yo, I be like... Yo, the gram got this old nigga soup like wonton. They got him really thinking that he bitch Magic Don Juan. Wearing the same shit my dad had on at mom's prom. And since y'all rooting for him, go get some pom-pom. This nigga ain't no pimp, he's just a rest haven. And I'm his worst nightmare. Wes Craven, with one punch, I can make his bony chest caving and leave him hanging same way Jay did to Haven. So what you talking about? You keep running your mouth, I'ma come up in your house and rip the plastic off your couch. You ain't the sensei smelling like Bengay. I'ma cut your toes off and now you Kunta Kinte. Oops, my bad, I meant Toby. Now you walking slowly. Let's have a moment of silence for Gianna and Kobe. Now I'm right back on Paw Paw. When I finish this round, y'all gon' say this Shaw Raw. No purple leather suit, this ain't Eddie Murphy flick. Demonstrating perfect spit to show you what I'm working with. I'm battling a throwback, old as Kojak. Down Cornelius call and said he want his clothes back. Bench stop game banging, but I'm with the drama still. And you know Piranha's wheel, snatch him out the Bonneville. Pick four bars and I bet you win the lotto. It's a John Wick hit, excommunicado. The king is back, Lima Beans is back, woo, and suddenly I'd like to leave your island. Man, you come right out of a comic book. Let me get him. I got in that ass in round one, and they said that L shook him. Got the internet screaming, who run it like Al Rookins? Diamonds are shining and blinding, I would avoid looking. I turn buck in the buffalo butt, that boy's bookman. Don't work a 9-to-5, I get the fast cash. I get the brace face and the ass lash. I make a dame dash, I ain't talking Rockefeller. And make her come back with some cheese, that's the mozzarella. I'm nasty over a beat, even an acapella. I make her put it in her mouth, call me Acanella. Now watch me rip a rapper, you little whippersnapper. I'm about to plan a funeral, somebody get the pastor and pick his casket out, write his obituary. Notify six of his friends that we can get to carry his body to the date. Lima just went berserk, this how it look when a old OG put in weight. Ever since the 70s, I rep my city, and you'll never see me sagging like some grandma titties, cause I keep my belt buckled, and you don't want to tussle. When was the last time your baby face felt some knuckles? I'm about to stick and move, and watch me bob and duck. I give them PhDs, a pumpkin head deluxe. Spit it hard with each verse, rapping till my teeth hurt. All I got to say now is Tabernacle Priest Church.
bro. The reveal on the high socks and the fucking capris, bro. At the end, like just not having those in the fucking the whole time, and then just suddenly having those in there. I gotta give it to LB, just not because of the bar work, they both had that, but like the fucking flavor in the voice, I just love that. Like the fucking, that whole scheme where he said like, go boys oik, put in woik, like that shit was fucking fire as hell. Hell yeah. It's incredible to hear his like ability to sound, like the, obviously you can tell it's the same person when you watch him back to back. But it's like, man, he does put in a lot to change. Like, that's a lot of dedication, like, to do a whole different delivery, to, like, really do it. Like, I got mad respect for that instead of just being like, I'm just going to put a costume on and rap, you know, different bars. Like, he fucking becomes that character. Like, he doesn't just rap different bars. Yeah. He fucking, he says them differently. He's got different flair, flavor, like, his whole fucking bravado. Like, style man.
Different. Yeah, it's kind of crazy.
But they both had fucking crazy, like, he had crazy bars on both of those. Like, that was nuts.
I honestly, I don't think I would have, if I didn't know any of the backstory, I would have never suspected those two to be the same person.
Dude, me and Zaro, we ain't that bright, okay? We fucking tripped on mushrooms for, like, 2 years, laughed at this guy endlessly, and we did not realize he's the same person until, like, a couple months ago. We were like, yo. You know what? I swear to God, bro. What the fuck?
That's fucking hilarious. You're just battles thinking like different people.
Yeah. John, dude, we get twisted and just fucking laugh our asses off to this dude's videos, bro. It's fucking hilarious.
Bro, I would have went down a fucking rabbit hole, like trying to figure out, okay, how did this fucking battle originate? Like, how did this, where did this beef come from? Like, what started?
Right.
Blah, 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 blah. And then fucking 16 and a half hours later, I would have found the fucking thing clarifying that those two are the same fucking person. I would have been pissed. What the fuck?
That's so fucking good.
No, you would not have been pissed. You would have been like, God damn, dude. Like,
spending 16 and a half hours fucking doing research? Hell yeah, I would have been pissed.
That's your fault, though. At least if you did 16 and a half hours, like, that's probably the best conclusion that you could ever find. Like, where did the beef originate? It's like they're the same person. Like, that's like, a, holy fuck, what?
That's fucking great.
Fight Club?
Yeah, dude. It's like, just like, Fight Club.
Damn. Is this the cutout of them, my boy?
Yeah, let's get out of here.
All right, boys. Fucking, hey, this has been another episode of Fuck Bro, the second official episode with our newest member, Mars One, but the first one that he actually attended, so.
And I'm going to get
warp.
I'll have my video warp, up warp. For the next one more consistently and shit.
Fuck Bro.
Same, we had some bad internet issues here, like I haven't even been able to see a lot of the videos, and mine's been cutting out a lot, so. Appreciate everybody tuning in as always. I'm going to make a bigger push next week to get us some musical submissions, but it's possible that we'll move to a format where we do a balance of both, like a couple of submissions from people that send them to the email and then a couple of our own curated submissions, because it's been kind of fun to have that extra element of hearing where somebody found a track and like hearing the backstory of like fucking how many different ways music creeps its way into our fucking lives. And like just all these different stories of where these fucking people heard these shits from, fucking videos that got shot and then fucking corrupted footage and never made, to fucking tripping on mushrooms and thinking a fucking battle that's been going on for years is like between two people and it's the same guy. Like, there's been some good fucking origin stories of these fucking tracks. So good shit, boys.
Definitely.
Hey bro, are you from Cass or Red Lake?